I'm keeping my fingers crossed, 'cause I know when I say it all, I lose. Now I count to 10 and breathe in before I fill the room with ammunition. My umbrella doesn't help, it's raining in my head. I hide my eyes, it's raining all the time. I'm sorry, I keep my fingers crossed. I know I lost, 'cause you believe I'm sorry. I keep my fingers crossed. I know I lost, 'cause you believe. I've been a wall, so you can't see. I'm only small, I just deny it all. I can't walk in a straight line, these thoughts grow inside. Eventually I'll implode.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Daily Onion Roast. Gather around with your pitchforks, grab some marshmallows, too. It's gonna be a wonderful time. How you guys doing? This has been some jazz. You like jazz? This has been one of my favorite albums that nobody has ever heard of because I'm a giant hipster. It's called Phase 5 by Yuri Honing and Floris, and it's this wonderful vocal jazz album. Not sure what the name of the singer is, unfortunately. It's so, underground. I heard it on, an online radio one time, and I loved it. It seems like you guys enjoyed it, too. That's good. So some interesting things have been happening recently with ya boy. Gregory, what's a good middle name for him? I don't know. What do you guys think for a good nickname for your boy? What should we call him? Snake Thing? Gregory Snake Thing Jackson? Gregory Stinky Jackson? How about OK Groomer Jackson? Gregory OK Groomer Jackson. I like that one. This is one of my favorite songs on this album. It's not on YouTube. This one's called Stay. Good fucking luck finding it. It's really hard to find. I might have to upload it myself, honestly. But, yeah, so a lot of interesting things have been happening with Onision recently. It was discovered recently, 2 days ago, I think. In fact, I believe it was discovered while I was streaming about Fena, my last live stream. It was discovered that Onision's daughter, back in the month of September, I believe, was left unattended in the upper floor of Greg's house, the second floor, and the window was open, and she fell out of the window two stories on hurt her head. She's still alive, but she has brain damage. It's very, very unfortunate, and as you can imagine, Greg responded as any parent would, any responsible parent would. He was apparently in the garage with the door locked at the time and didn't hear the child's screams. So she was forced to walk to the garage after falling out of the second floor of his house, knock on the garage door so her dad would, you know, give her the time of day. And then I believe he took video footage of her during this before calling the police. I believe that's what happened. Because he wanted to... I'm not sure why. There's a lot of theories as to why he chose to do that. But that's what he did, apparently. We're going to get into this stuff. We're going to get into some of the details. I have to give a major shout-out to a Twitter account named... I'm sure a lot of you know this person, Onision Unprivated. I wanted some info about his... part of the reason I'm streaming today was because I woke up to a copyright claim... on, of all videos, the Onision music video that I did fucking months and months ago. And I was like, I don't know, I was just incensed by this. I was like, your fucking daughter fell out of a window and everybody is calling you out on being criminally fucking negligent. And you're, like, taking the time out of your day to go into an ancient video of mine and copyright strike it. Or a copyright claim it, not a strike, that's more serious, but it was a claim. And the video was already claimed. I have received no money from this video since I put it out. But it was just absurd to me that during all of this shit, he would have the gall to go back to an ancient fucking video of mine from like a year ago almost. And copyright claim it. It was insane to me. So I wanted to do some fair use adventuring and look at his Twitter and such. And I found out this morning that his entire fucking Twitter has been wiped. Presumably because it's filled with insane, disgusting nonsense, which we're going to be reading today. But yeah, not his entire Twitter, but a lot of his tweets are gone. And some of his recent, like, if you scroll like 10 tweets back, you're seeing stuff from 2016. Like, it's pretty bare at this point. We're going to be looking at some of the stuff that he deleted. And we're going to be listening to a leaked Discord call. We might be looking into his cult as well. There's all sorts of things to talk about with your boy. And his vegan, vegetarian body. So what's going on, chat? Why are you bullying the Onion Man? Is this the only time that I'm... You know what? No, this is not a bully stream. This is just a fair use facts stream. I don't even want to say that I'm bullying him. I'm just telling you the facts as they've been laid out. And, you know, I might make some jokes. But jokes are fine. He makes jokes, too. He's made jokes about Eugenia Cooney having a medical condition, so that's fine. Buddy! I need a not a bully stream shirt. We are actually currently discussing merch. Big Deadwing Dork alert. Pew News alert. There is merch in discussion. We're talking about doing some interesting stuff with some of the artists of the Sicko Army. We're talking about my idea, because I watched the Nerd City video about YouTuber merch, and I liked the idea. I liked what he said about Elvis the Alien stuff and how it's kind of like its own thing that's just a cool, like, design that doesn't really specifically mean anything to... Like, people aren't going to ask you what the catchphrase on your shirt means. But I also kind of like the idea of some catchphrases. We're thinking of Feller with a hard R.
And I'm thinking of something where it kind of like, it's kind of like incorporated in a semi-subtle way into an interesting design that you would just wear as like a shirt. So that's kind of the vibe I'm thinking of for the Deadwing merch. But yeah, that's being talked about, just a brief mention. Because I have seen a few people talk about I want a Not a Bully Stream t-shirt, and I think I want one too, so... I've actually talked about, there's one I have in mind that's like trippy, psychedelic, I don't know how to describe it, but it's pretty cool. Justice for Snake Thing. Yeah, no, that's okay. What a sellout. Yeah, you're right, dude. I'm the king of the sellouts. I'm sure he has his fan base look for videos that paint him in a negative light so he can copyright claim them. I'm sure he does too. I'm not gonna watch anything from one of his channels today. I'm not gonna watch any Uh-Oh Bro. I considered watching Uh-Oh Bro because I haven't looked at that channel yet. I haven't looked at a lot of it. I think I saw one video from it. But yeah, there's a bunch of channels that Onision has on YouTube that I could look at, but I'm not going to do that because I'm a fully fair use streamer, okay? The fair use bear is here for a reason, goddammit. I am a fair use streamer, and I do not infringe. No infringes. I'm just going to be reading his own words, his tweets, which have been archived by independent people. Which is not illegal. It's not against the rules of YouTube. Not against the rules of copyright or anything like that. I'm not going to be doing anything that infringes on anybody. Although we are going to be listening to a Discord call that features him and a bunch of fucking teenagers that are in his Discord. Which is who he looks to for validation, apparently. I guess that could be considered like a personal property or something. But, I mean, it's been posted by a third party and watched by thousands of people. So, I don't know. That's a bit of a hill to die on. But I'd be very interested to see if Greg decides to copyright claim this stream. It is going to stay up. It's going to stay archived. I'm very interested to see if he decides to copyright claim it because, what's funny is he likes to threaten people with lawsuits. And that would be really unfortunate for him if he got threatened with a lawsuit for flagrantly infringing or, it's copyright fraud, basically. It's like illegally claiming a video that is in complete fair use and using your footage for like review and critique and such. So, I mean, I don't know. It'd be really unfortunate if that happened to him. But let's take a look at some super chats and things here. We got $2 from Abby Wheeler. Do you like kombucha? People have been saying kombucha a lot, and I'm not sure if I get this meme. I'm not sure if I understand the kombucha meme. $5 from Taylor Busby. I've seen septic tanks with more creative talent and personal charisma than Onision. If he'd had the drive, I'm sure he'd be a serial killer. Well, not to put any words in anybody's mouth, but some people in the Discord earlier were talking about his striking resemblance to Luca Magnotta. So, and also Heaven's Gate. We are probably going to look at his cult today, so there's that. That's a little bit alarming, I would say. $2 from DinoAss6969. Awesome music. Here's to a good stream. Thank you. Once again, this is one of my favorite albums. It's so hard to find on YouTube, though. I think there's a couple songs that I added to my music playlist that I mentioned, which, by the way, hello, I have a music playlist. If you'd like to hear some more Deadwing douche tunes, you can check that out. But I've got a couple songs from this on that playlist, but a lot of it's hard to find. But it's called the album is Phase 5 by Yuri Honing and Floris, and that song was called Swallow, I believe. €2 from Match Term Greg Cry Onion Jackson. That's pretty good. Victoria Catherine with $2. Please say Keely is Big Daddy. Well, there you go. Big Daddy. $5 from Connor McClory. No message. Thank you. $2 from Test Subject 306. Onision would get his salad tossed in jail. Yeah, funny thing about all those tweets about how people are literally designed to love his cock. Which, yes, those are tweets that he's made. I've coined the term Daddy Dom on Maine. And that's what he's doing. He's being Daddy Dom on Maine. And it's very uncomfortable and weird. But yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how, you know, who's literally designed to love his cock in prison. You know, that's going to be a really interesting time. $2 from Tiana Mjolen. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong. Greg, let me film this real quick, Jackson. Something like that. $2 from Connor McClory again. No way in hell am I missing this one. Get his ass. We're gonna teach him a lesson. You know, we're gonna take him to church. Well, probably not, honestly. I mean, everybody's already talking about this. This is old news at this point. But I mean, most of this is. But you know, it's fine. I like I've said before, I didn't want to do another Onision video. I actually considered, though, after the daughter falling out of the window thing happened, after the Fena stream the other day, I was like, I might do like a quick on camera, just please arrest this guy. Just please get this over with. This has gone on long enough. This fucking circus. This just have him in prison. This is all just have it done, you know? I was gonna do a video like that, but then I was like, nah, you know, it's fine. And now we're doing a stream, and we're kind of going to cover a lot of the final things that I guess I wanted to talk about with Onision. I have been curious to look into his cult, so we're going to look at that, and, you know, we're going to look into some of the recent events. We'll be reading his tweets. It's going to be a wonderful extravaganza, everybody. Let's see, $5 from Razmataz Bean. You ever just let your kid fall out a window and follow that up with some horny tweets and kombucha, like, rather than empathy or anything? Yeah, I don't know if I mentioned that, but he was tweeting, like sexting. He was doing that shit. He was talking about like putting his cum in the reader's mouth or whatever while his daughter was like in intensive care. So, I mean, I'm going to go with a very hefty, chufty yikes on that one. Big, thick, chufty yikes. And, like, there's nothing wrong with some fucking dominant daddy stuff, I guess, if you want to do that. But, first of all, maybe don't do it on fucking Maine. And maybe don't do it while your daughter's in the hospital, you sick weirdo. You are not even deserving of the sicko title, you know that? $5 from Lesbian. It's not that he didn't hear the screams, it's just that the little girl's screaming is white noise to him at this point. Oh! Oh! Okay, the 13th Amendment made it illegal to own people like that, Miss Lesbian. But thank you. $2 from Corpseykins. She had a subdural hematoma. I had one. Perma-fucked. Yes, that's what I've heard. It's basically lifelong brain damage, which is very unfortunate, considering she's probably also already got developmental problems based on, like, being this guy's kid. You know, like, living around him shrieking in a Batman costume all day. $2 from Da Vegan Zombie. Predator's Gregma deserves to be bullied, though. Well, you know, you're right. There is definitely some call to bully somebody for their criminal negligence that led to the permanent, like, brain damage of their daughter. But, you know, that would not even be necessary, honestly. It's sort of like the Channeling Eric video where I was just like, here's just the facts, you know? What do you have to say about this? And I think I know what everybody has to say, more or less. Hang on, we need some more music. We need some more music. Oh, well, that's like most of the songs from that album that I like. It's a pretty good album, but it's only got a few like really great songs. Hang on. I need some more choice OST. Oh shit, grocery store sounds. Yes. I love this one. Dude, this fucking album is a bop. Put this shit on. Lull your kids to sleep with this fucking shit. This album is great. All right, got our music queued up here. Let's see. $5 from Lesbian again. I would buy a shirt with your bear doing the Rich Evans masturbation face on it. That's really good, honestly. That would be good. It could be like, it could say sex weirdo and everything. That would be so good. That's a good, somebody fucking take note of that suggestion. Thank you, Lesbian. $2 from Taylor Busby. Shake my head, dirty onion fellers. Oh, it's breaking out the hard R's on this one. $10 from Lola Ray. Onions fucked up for Onision's fucked up for that. As a child care worker, I'm seething about him. I want to take his kids home and show them what parental love is. Yes, we have a soon-to-be mother in our Discord who is similarly very violently upset about this. And she's seething as well. It's anybody probably would. I'm not a parent, but you know, like, what the fuck, dude? It's like anybody would feel this way, but parents and, you know, caregivers especially. 5,000 yen from Skella Chicken Lives. I thought your name said Shekelstein for a minute. Skella Chicken Lives with 5,000 yen. I think it's only fair that he sees some use in prison sometime in the near future. Well, you know, the chat said it, not me. $2 from Taylor Thiest. Dunk on Gregma, Daddy Claw. Please, the daddy thing has been ruined forever now, thanks to Greg. You know that much? You know that? Like, it's very bad. It's kind of like emojis after fucking snake thing. $2 from Poral of Earth. Grape Dick Gregory. Ah, yes, the baby carrot. Baby's bouncing on his baby carrot. Gregory Baby Carrot Jackson. Very good. $5 from Pelamus McSoy. I'd pay money for a Deadwing plushie bear. Yeah, it's going to be weird considering my bear is basically a hodgepodge of Winnie the Pooh and Banjo-Kazooie Banjo. I guess there's a hook hand and he looks depressed. And he's like enough of both that he's not enough of either, I guess. But I feel like it might run into some copyright problems, maybe. $3 from Ben Crabtree. Greg dumped kombucha on himself and screamed. Oh, I must have missed that. $10 from Lohawk-sama. Honestly, I thought Snake Thing was the worst thing ever, but Onion Boy is keeping pace with him. Onion Boy, Onision is like not as bad, obviously, as Snake Thing. Obviously, he's not as bad as Snake Thing, but he is a very fucked up person, in my opinion, and should probably face jail time for all of the things that he's done that are verifiably illegal. At the very least. 100 rubles from F.U. Susan. The saddest thing is that apparently there was not enough evidence for the CPS to get involved. Grug's kid is basically a potato right now. So there's not enough evidence, apparently? This is insane. How is this fucking man, like, slip-sliding away from all this shit? I don't think he can keep it up forever. Like, I don't think he can keep doing the Matrix bullet dodge all this whole time, you know? $2 from Space Corps. I'm going to Tampa. Have you been? No, but I'm considering going to VidCon this year. So, you know, maybe stop by for that. $5 from Pelamus McSoy again. But in all seriousness, nail this bastard for negligence. If that happened to my niece, I'd be freaking out. Yeah, I mean, once again, parents and caregivers especially. Anybody with, like, I don't really have any kids in my life, but, you know, I like kids, I guess. I was a kid. I don't know. I like myself when I was a kid. That was before I developed deep-seated inner hatred. So, you know, kids must be doing something right. So, yeah, it's like, I feel like anybody feels that way. But, yeah, especially caregivers and parents. $2 from Razzmatazz Bean. Onision has nothing on Snake Thing. No, he's not exactly a Snake Thing. But he's pretty interesting person, you know. $5 from Louise Barbosa. Onion Boy's breakdown video is where kombucha meme is from. Oh, okay. I haven't actually watched those, and sadly for you guys, I'm not going to watch them because that would be Onision's copyrighted content. So we wouldn't want to infringe now, would we? We wouldn't want to do that. That's bad. $2 from Test Subject 306. Let me just sext you while my daughter is dying. Yeah, that's once again, chufty yikes. $5 from Jolly Grapefruit. Hey, medic, I like Onision. Onision, more like Oquircion. And then there's some, like, Arabic. I'm sorry, I don't speak that, but thank you. $5 from Farglehorn. I don't know why people say Onision is a bad parent. He clearly loves kids. Oh, yes, obviously. Wasn't there evidence that fucking Kai, like, knew that he was a weirdo when they had a daughter? like, when they found out that it was going to be a daughter, apparently Kai was, like, crying. Kai's crying, guys, but apparently,
uh-oh, I almost uttered the bad word. I almost said the bad pronoun.
Apparently Kai knew that Greg was kind of weird around, you know, young girls and was crying because of it. So there's that. You know, I don't know how true that is, but that's what I heard. Let's see. $5 from Leo the Bum Tickler with an exclamation mark. Notices your big chunky brown bear bum. Oh, fucking whoa. Well, there you go, lads. We've got an oh whoa, an unironic oh whoa. Thank you. $5 from Lawn Care. Say penis at the end of the stream. YouTube doesn't like the P word. Oh, okay. Well, I say penis at the end of every stream, pretty much. So, I mean, you know, I think I got my bases covered there. $2 from Dynamo. Mans went from a banana man to a kitty diddler. You know, it's funny how things happen like that. £5 from the maddest of dudes. And I thought Vic Mignogna, I have no idea how to say that, was a fucked up POS with his lawyers being the most incompetent son of a bitch. But Onision's tweets make me shit bricks. I mean, I don't know. I know a lot of people support Vic Mignogna. I know a lot of people support him. I don't know enough about him to really talk on it, but I've heard some things. I've heard some things about the other people that are, like, accusing him, though, so I don't know. Not knowledgeable about that one, but thank you. $5 from Mae Madison. Greg should see prison time, if only because his content is worse than at least 3 murders. Yes, if any of you don't know, I have 3 videos where I shit on Onision's terrible videos. His vlog stuff, his music in the second one, and the third one months later was his comedy, quote-unquote. It's a wonderful trilogy of garbage. Let's see. $2 from the Blue Bow, or Bow. Onision would agree with Fena's portrayal of Bob. Yeah, I kind of think that's true. I don't know. I'm not sure, but I feel like you're right. 420 from Robert Williams. Got home from work just in time. Oh, you know, strap in. This is going to be an exciting one. Whenever I'm done these fucking super chats, would you people please stop? No, it's okay. It's fine. $2 from Dynamo. Sooner or later, we'll take him down. Or enough will take him down. Yeah, again, there's enough stuff that's verifiably happened that he's, like, verifiably guilty of that I don't know. I'm not sure how much... I don't know how much longer we can sustain this, Captain. The ship's... I'm giving it all we got. You know, like, I don't know how much is left. I don't know. Hopefully not much. $5 from Basan Kappa. Kombucha tastes like year-old vinegar that someone farted and sprayed perfume in. Yes, I've heard such things. I never tasted it, but I remember... was it L.A. Beast drinking, like, a gallon of it and vomiting everywhere? That was fun. I used to have a thing... I used to be really into the, like, reckless eating and L.A. Beast and stuff like that. The big vomit challenges. I like that shit. Maybe that's the precursor to the party cheese salad. There you go. Let's see. $2 from Abby Wheeler. Give us your best hentai moan, Clawfather. Oh, that's worth more than $2. Sorry, I have self-esteem. But try again next year. $2 from Luis Barbosa. Watch the vocoded breakdowns, Lamau. They're great. No, because that's technically his content. We wouldn't want to infringe, everybody. Come on. $5 from Arc Monarch. Tell my friend Riley his opinion sucks on Pokemon waifus is shit. Thanks, Clawdaddy. P.S. Margaret Thatcher is dead. Wasn't she already dead? Oh, well, F's in chat, I guess. $2 from Taylor Busby. Greg, justifiably a targeted individual Jackson. Yes, very, very much so. I don't think anybody's going to ask questions about that one. $5 from Ale Titan. Just watching this before class starts, the professor is making us play one of those introduce yourself games. I'd rather listen to your stream. This sucks. Man, school sucks. Well, thank you. And don't worry, the rest of the stream will be saved later, so you can skip the 40 minutes of intro. They're getting longer every time. Like, I just have stuff to say, and I like hanging out with you guys. It's fun. Before we get into the scum of the earth. listening to some tunes, you know? It's a good time. Let's see. 5 pounds from Nidamok. Does the daughter have perm brain damage? Just got here. I believe so, yes. It's quite sad. Once again, you're just getting here. Him and the spouse left the daughter unattended on a second floor, on the second floor of their house with the window open, and she fell out the window, and the 2-year-old daughter suffered permanent brain damage and had to, after falling out of the window, walk to the garage and knock on the door so her dad would hear her. So that's real fucking nice. But we'll get into that. Don't worry. $2 from Squid. He was probably excited to learn he had a daughter. Well, I mean, it's not like he, I don't know why you would say that. It's not like he ever, you know, adopted a girl for the sole purpose of, you know, raising her up to be fuck meat. That never happened, okay? Don't put words in anybody's mouth. Come on. That's not fair. Don't be mean to Greg. He's done nothing wrong. $2 from I'm O-Wave, giving him all the party cheese salad. Yeah, he has to take it all. He has to be a good little bitch. I'm gonna call you slut. Eat it all, slut.
Yeah, that's what he needs. $10 from Razzmatazz Bean. I love dunking on James Jackson, but hold up. Mr. Peanut, like the Planters 3D peanut capitalist mascot, is dead? The Planters company says he's dead? What is happening? Was he allergic to peanuts? Guys, I think we might need to change the topic of the stream. Alert, everybody. Mr. Peanut is fucking dead. I can't believe fucking Mr. Peanut is dead. They done my boy dirty. They done my boy extremely dirty. I don't know about that. That sounds crazy. I guess rest in peace. F's in chat. F for Mr. Peanut. $10. Thank you, sir. $5 from Lola Ray. As bad as it sounds, I think Onion made his kid fall so when she's, as he would see fit, ripe for the picking, he could get away with any sexual abuse. I don't know if I agree with that much. I feel like that's a little bit far. But I have theorized similarly that the accident, I don't know, just my opinion, just my pure speculative theory opinion, not anything wrong with that, but I theorized that potentially it might have been not as much of an accident as people think. You know, that's just my theory. That's just an opinion. You know, perfectly okay to say that. Not an accusation whatsoever. $2 from the Blue Bow. Onion gives Kai $100 after fights and conflicts. Yikes. Like, with them? Like, with each other? Or, like, with other people? That's weird. Their whole entire relationship is weird. And I'm going to hopefully avoid fucking that entire landmine, that entire minefield as much as I can. I guess I'll quote Elise here, because she's one of my preferred Onision coverage channels. She does a lot more than that, but I'll paraphrase Elise here, and I'll say that, Greg... Greg likes to habitually defeminize his spouses, his significant others. He likes to shave their heads and make them wear men's clothing and things like that. And Kai is definitely a victim of his. And I'm just going to leave it at that, you know? You guys can talk about that amongst yourselves. I'm not gonna go into that any further. Thank you for that technique, Elise. I appreciate it. Just let them fight about it. It's fine. $5 from Mark Mendez. I'm worried he might just show the court his books so he can plead insanity. Yeah. Just show him the third book. It's fine. Okay, I'm going to cut it here. I'm going to look at some more super chats later. This has gone on long enough, Snake! It's time to get into the meat, the real juicy shack meat of the stream, everybody. Thank you, everybody, but we will be catching up with this in a little bit. It's just coming in a little too hot. We're coming in fast. So let's get into things here now. Where should I start? Where should I start? I need to, let's see, I saved a bunch of tweets. Once again, big shout outs for all of the streams. Like a lot of the stuff that, most of the stuff that we're looking at today is going to be thanks to Onision Unprivated. And some other accounts on Twitter that she retweeted, I believe. But I think a lot of it was Onision Unprivated on Twitter. Very good account for spicy Greg news. As I said before, you know, actually, I guess the first thing we should do is we should look at, Greg's, Twitter, his current active Twitter, where we find Onision, and we can see private Twitter, Onision Prime. As you can see, he's mostly moved on to his private Twitter. Sadly, we won't get to see many of these 364 tweets. That's almost one for every day of the year, you know. But we will get to see some of them. There's some insight into the new world of Onision. But yeah, as you can see, he's deleted a lot of things from 30th of December 2019. 8th of December, 5th, and then, like, June, he's got some fucking Eugenia Cooney bait here. He's also changed his picture to him as a baby, so I guess, like, for sympathy or something, I'm not sure, but, you know, there's that, which is just lovely. Yeah, but as you can see, we've got tweets after this one from July, or June, rather, we see stuff from, like, 2017, early 2017. Muslim does not equal. He's like, he deleted everything that doesn't make him look like a good person. Who won the debate? Who lost the debate? Answer: America. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Remember, everybody, I'm not gonna say anything. I certainly don't like either of the parties that were involved in this, but just remember which side of the aisle fucking Greg wants to claim that he was on. He's so weird politically, if you think about him, because he's like, he tries to be all edgy, but he also tries to do the whole SJW thing with, like, constant, like, LGBT baiting, hello, hi, give me good boy points, I'm a good person, I promise, kind of shit. So it's weird. He's a very weird individual in that way. Guys, this breaks my heart. You know, so as you can see, these are tweets. Wasn't there one here? Wasn't there one here where he talks about fucking Leafy? Yeah, people are saying Leafy viewbotted to get famous. He's shitty, but he's cute. Yeah, I mean, well, he's got no fucking chin, but, you know. Yeah, we got tweets here about Leafy, everybody. And this is, like, not that far down on his Twitter. So as you can see, most of his stuff on the main Twitter has been scrubbed. And apparently, it, like, after a certain point, everything is gone. I think after a certain point, he's gotten rid of everything. Maybe this is that point. So, like, everything pre-2015, I guess, is just gone. So, yeah, Greg did that. Yeah, so, you know, very interesting why someone would delete fucking everything, you know, in the midst of a supposed FBI investigation and their fucking, you know, criminal negligence toward their daughter. But, that's pretty interesting stuff. Again, unfortunately, we can't look at Onision Prime here. We can't look at that because it is a private account. He's retreated into his safe space, everybody. We've even got a picture here as a header from that video where he's out in public looking like a weirdo, and a little Asian man, like, gives him the stink eye because he looks like such a weirdo, and he kind of looks like Tommy Wiseau, but that's kind of taking Tommy Wiseau's name in vain. Yeah, that music video, about all about her lies. Yeah, so unfortunately we can't enter Onision's safe space. That's very, very sad. But, you know, and we can't see too many of his tweets about, as I mentioned, he was busy being Daddy Dom on Maine when his daughter was in the hospital, but you're not going to see any evidence of that here. Stop calling me the Joker. Well, you're just such a fucking clown, Greg. I don't know. Oh yeah, apparently Mr. Peanut is fucking dead, I guess. Rest in peace. But yeah, most of those tweets, all of those tweets are now gone. It's all just like spread positivity and garbage like that. So yeah, that's the state of the absolute state of his current Twitter. It's very interesting stuff. If we fade back to the bear here, take a look at chat real quick. Oy vey, Onision is a gun cell. Some call me the space pedo. I did not. Switch to live chat here. I don't know why it defaults to the top chat. I hate that. Greg, I'm closer to 40 than 20 and still dressed like a 14-year-old cuck man. Says chat member. Not me. I'm definitely not bullying anybody. Shit, what the fuck did I type party cheese scaffism for? Onision has kids. Oh, yes, he has kids, and he's very much hurt one of his kids through criminal negligence, as we've recently learned. A 35-year-old safe space. Imagine him singing to Good Charlotte in the bathroom while drinking beer. I am imagining that. I'm also thinking about those beans. In a society! Oh, hi, DeadwingDork. A based coomer. Yes, I think Onision's weird daddy dom on main shit while his daughter is in intensive care for brain damage is truly peak coomer. I think he's truly... is this what it means to coom? To truly coom? I think this is what cooming truly is. Very exciting. So, what should we look at first here? Well, you know, let's get up our boy. Get up a pretty, pretty image of him. This is from, like, recently. This is on his Instagram, I think, where he's using filters to make himself look like some kind of alien. I don't know. He kind of looks like Paul Zimmer. Jesus Christ. Oh God, I hate it. I threw up in my mouth. Get it away. There he is! The BG. Yeah, that's our boy. That's him. So, we're going to keep that in the background there. Let's see. Well, first, here's a tweet that didn't age well. You can see why he might have wanted to delete this one.
Stand in front of the window over there. The world should see how pathetic and helpless you are. I'm going to humiliate you, and right before you lose consciousness, I'm going to destroy you.
Yeah. Didn't age well. Not a good tweet, in hindsight. It's pretty unfortunate, actually, if you think about it. But, yeah. Did not age well. Age like milk, yes. Let's see. What else do we got here? I have a whole folder of just like tweets. I'm trying to figure out where all of them are in order. Oh, we can listen to the recording of his arrest. Or no, not his arrest. The recording of when he called the cops about fucking Chris Hansen being at his door. To paraphrase Alizi, you can imagine being the 911 operator at that point in time when somebody calls you up and says, "Hi, I'm being harassed by someone. They're at my door. What's their name? Oh, Chris Hansen. Oh, okay, so you're a fucking nonce then. All right." But yeah, we can listen to that in a little bit. I'd like to show this first. This is a little more serious, a little more dour. This is the report, which talks about all of this. On 09-12-19, around 19:08 hours, Deputy Mancuso, 522, and I responded to a medical aid call at Onision's house, where an accident involving Onision and Kai's children occurred, unrelated to abuse and grooming, etc. I remembered the location because I had done a welfare check with CPS about 10 days prior. Ah, yes. CPS informed me on that incident that Juve Vic, I don't know how to read these things, but James Jackson had been communicating with minors and was possibly sexually abusing young girls. In this incident, there was no evidence or information that would allow me to place at least one child into CPS custody. James said that while waiting for the ambulance, he took a video showing the aftermath of the incident. I asked James why he took the video. James said he wanted to be able to show the doctor the aftermath of the incident and expressed concern about the health of his child in relation to the accident. That's definitely the reason. It has nothing to do with anything else, or definitely nothing. Nothing like, I don't know. I have no idea why he would take video of the daughter, honestly. I don't buy his excuse for why he did. But I have no idea why he would. I don't know. It's very weird. He also said that he thought about needing to show the police what happened and spoke about an incident in 2011 when a friend threatened to kill herself and made it look like he was responsible. So he took a video of himself. Okay, so yeah, he wanted to, like, clear his own ass. Before he even called the fucking ambulance, he wanted to, like, make sure he was in the clear. Fuck the daughter who just fell out of the window. No, I need to be okay. I need to cover my ass. That's at least what it seems like from this. So he took a video of himself calling 911 so he could show the police he was not responsible. Yeah, just because you call 911 doesn't mean you're not responsible, Greg. But all right. And you are responsible because you left your fucking daughter alone unprotected in a room with an open window. So... yeah, a little bit responsible. James's explanation for why he took a video seemed strange to me, says the deputy or officer or whatever this is. On 9/12/19, at approximately 19:25 hours, I received a call from Deputy Grote regarding an incident that occurred at Onision's house. Deputy Grote explained that James Jackson called 911 and reported that an accident occurred involving one of his children. Deputy Grote said that he had been out to the residence before to assist Child Protective Services in checking the children due to concerns that James ran a YouTube channel with content about child molestation. Well, not exactly, but you know, yes. So once again, the cops are aware of Greg. Eyes on Breen, everybody. Eyes on Breen. So, what should we read next? Well, I guess we can get started with his fucking... Oh, here's one that I like. Here's one that's personally funny to me. He apparently tried to use 4chan as a fucking personal army. Which you'd think if you've been on the internet for long enough, you'd know not to do. But, yeah. Apparently... What do we got here? What I like about the 4chan community, rational human beings. Different of opinions equals interesting. Discussion. Different of opinions equals interesting, everybody. I agree. I agree with that. Hang on. Let me get some more music for this. We need some more fucking music. Where's the rest of my herbs music? Hold on. We're about to get this shit bopping. Don't even worry about it. All right, we're gravy, at least for a little bit. But yeah, little to no bias on 4chan. Stands up for people who need it. I'd like to suggest offering your support to Onision. If you don't know him, now is a great time to check him out, smiley face. I personally am a fan of his and have been for years. Onision has been falsely accused of grooming, and he does groom his facial hair. Well, that's not true. There's images now of him with, like, a beard where he looks like fucking Grandpa Dante from DMC5. An uncomfortable amount like Grandpa Dante. Thank you very much. He can fucking shave anytime he wishes. But he does groom his facial hair. For the record, these lies were created by vindictive women he dumped. Women who are not credible, as they openly admit to using drugs, are unemployed, and have many other problems. Most of these same people have contacted him in the past, asking for him. Keep in mind him, everybody. Just keep in mind him. To reconsider their relationship. He denied them. Because of Onision's fame, many people try to use both him and his husband, Kai. Chris Hansen, a man who has committed illegal acts and lost his career, is also using Onision's name and popularity to benefit himself. Patreon, a website he was doing really great on and allowed him to connect with his fans, now only wants to host liberal extremists and SJWs. If you don't fit their views, they will kick you off, even when claims are proven false. Let's give Onision our support, everybody. Liars shouldn't win. Another great example of media bias is how they are always trying to claim Onision fans are underage edgelords. False. Both Google and YouTube analytics show half my audience is 18+. They call him the most honest YouTuber for a reason. A facts machine, if you will. He also likes this website, I heard, so even more reason to support him. Through it all, Onision still smiles, and in the end, happiness and being good to others is all that matters. Remember that, okay? Thanks. Thanks, anonymous Onision fan. Thank you for your call to action. We appreciate it, anonymous fan of Onision. Maybe that's uh-oh, bro. Maybe that's not Greg. It's uh-oh, bro, that's doing that that post. I don't know. But that's pretty good. What does the chat think about that? What does the chat have to say? Him. My. My. T. Onision, yes. Uh-oh, stinky. My sides are in orbit. Yeah. I want to see Fortran's response. Sadly, I didn't see that, but... Oh, don't play the same song twice. God damn it. Let's see. What do we got next? What's next on the plate? Okay, so... I guess it's time to get into the Daddy Dom on Main stuff, isn't it? All right, everybody. I want you to prepare your vomit buckets, okay? We're about to listen to Greg try to fucking Dom us. We're about to listen to Greg talk about putting his cum in our mouths. You ready? I'm in a department store. Well, get the fuck out, dude. Oh, jeez. One viewer left the stream. Daddy, no. I'll forgive you calling me daddy just this once. Just this once. But yeah. Hashtags where someone is over are so lame and outdated. You know what's not lame and outdated? You begging me to dominate you. Me fucking you senseless against the refrigerator as you struggle to form words thanks to your rolled back eyes and incoherent moaning. Ooh, woo. This is some real ooh, woo stuff, guys. Isn't that sexy? Aren't y'all aroused? Yo, aim! Stay back! Disgusting. This is too far, Deadwing. Dude, we just started. I think this might be worse than the snake thing stream for some people. Oh, damn. I'm sorry to be you guys. I had to actually see all this before to save them. But what do we got here? What's this one? You're such a perfect, beautiful slut. Thanks, Greg. I appreciate it. I feel like a perfect slut, you know?
You will come when I let you, not a moment sooner.
Cool. That's so hot, guys. What's this one? Oh, this one's called suckme.jpg.
Let me suck your tits till you lactate, then I'll let you suck me.
This is one that I remember apparently in like leaked conversations of his with women. He often uses the phrase suck me, which sounds a little bit... I don't like that one. I don't like the suck me. That's not how boobs work. Not exactly. Big yikes energy. I agree. Chufty yikes, everybody. Here's this one, which takes the good name of Aubrey Plaza in vain. Thank you very much.
When you read an Onision tweet and dream of it later that night, please tell me I came inside you.
So I don't know who he thinks he's talking to here. Did he have like a groundswell of support?
Was he just trying to be, like, outrageous so people would notice him, Senpai? Was that what was happening? I don't know. I'm not sure what his game, like, his end game was with this, but... But don't be fucking doing... Don't be doing my Aubrey Plaza dirty like that, Greg. You come on. You are literally designed to enjoy my cock. I am literally designed to bring you to the point of orgasm and beyond. Our purpose is clear. I'm here to breed you and you to carry my seed.
What's going on, chat? This is the saddest thing I've ever seen. Can't do shit with that carrot. Yeah, the baby carrot, you know? The baby fucking carrot. Twitter for Android. To orgasm and beyond! Okay, what's this one? What's this one?
Which way would you have it? Make me a mommy. Use me as a fuck toy. Dominate me, daddy. All of the above.
Yeah, I mean, again, like, you know that you're being investigated for grooming a 14-year-old, right? Like, I don't get the thought process here. This seems like a bad idea, you know? Who retweets this? The cringe. Not a good look.
What a time to jump in. This is going to be a lot of the stream.
You'd rather listen to Snake Thing or Woof, you know? Honestly, the Onision voice that I do is pretty similar to Snake Thing as is.
Let's see. What do we got now?
If you think my words make you feel a certain way, you should see what my hips can do.
Oh my god, just go to jail already. Thank you, Bitcoin whore. Thank you, Bitcoin whore, for your service. I like the onion voice. Oh god, fuck. Fucking hell. Let's see here. What do we got next?
Don't be embarrassed. Your ass looks perfect when you're on all fours. You have nothing to hide.
Uh-huh.
Hurry up and recover. I want to fuck you again.
Oh, that's so sexy, you know? It's just so... It's really getting me going. Oh, this one's great. This is my favorite.
If you love beyond meat in your mouth, you should try vegetarian dick in your other holes.
I like how this one down here still just says, oh my god, just go to jail already. That's good. We need to just have this down here ever present for the whole stream. God is dead, based and dead armed. What does that even mean? Bitcoin horror is going strong. These tweets are Greg's future exploits in jail. I'm gonna coom! The pinnacle of man, ladies and gentlemen. Beat the meat! Feed the meat to the gherkin, everybody. I mean, feed the gherkin to the meat, rather. What do we got for this one?
Stop sending me friend requests. I don't want to be your friend.
Is it because I'm over 15?
Oh!
That 13th Amendment means nothing to you people, damn.
If you're looking for a sign God exists, look no further. I'm here.
And then a reply from the same account. I mean, God got a 14-year-old pregnant, and that sounds about right in your case.
Oh, 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 I'm cooming. Oh,
it is illegal to own people like this. Yes.
Shots have been fired. Cooming hard. You've entered the coom room. Yes. That's some pretty good responses. They balance out the disgust of his actual tweets.
Thoughts and prayers for your pussy to have a speedy recovery. Love you, babe.
What pussy? What? Who are you talking about? I thought you had a husband, Greg. Okay.
I want to hurt you in ways that make you wet.
I should have saved the picture that was posted a couple times in relation to these pictures. That was, whoops, can't send that tweet. It looks like you've already said that a bunch of fucking times, you piece of shit. We get it. That was a good tweet. Or that was a good picture. I like that. And of course, I was so glad when this was the perfect like thumbnail ratio. Like, look at this. This called to me. I knew the moment I saw this that I had to do a stream. The moment I saw this, it was like, yeah, I've got my thumbnail. I know what this one's going to... This one is going to go hard. Potion of pussy recovery +5. Please stop laughing! Everybody, stop laughing, okay? How dare you? Stop laughing at him, guys! He's a legend! Guys, he's a legend! What are you doing? Don't laugh! Stop laughing! Oh, what a fucking cunt. I mean, not a bully stream. What's this one? Sometimes I forget how famous I am. Everyone is constantly talking about me. Drop that one. Yeah, everybody's talking. Everybody, I don't know if the, you know, Greg Jackson really stretches the limits of any publicity is good publicity, you know? I think we know now that that's not necessarily true. Hang on. There you go. Let's see.
Why does everyone want to be my friend? I do not want to be your friend.
Everybody wants to be Greg's friend, everyone. Everybody's just so ready to be friends with slime time over here. I believe it. I know I believe it. Do you guys believe it? I believe it. I used to work in a jail, and I guarantee you a jail officer might let slip his record to Big Bubba, who has a thing for pedos. Onision, your sock puppets don't count. Yeah. Keep going here.
Like so many people writing me saying, hey, can we be buddies? Hey, want to be friends? Who the fuck are you?
Joking. Don't answer that. Go away. Yeah, everybody wants to be Greg's friend. I don't know what he's trying to do with these tweets, you know? Like, this is what's most confusing to me is, like, does he think people are going to believe him? Is he trying to, like... Is it trying to, like, troll people, I guess? Into, like, getting mad or something? I'm not sure. I mean, listen, hey, I'm perfectly okay with giving him the attention that he needs. Some people are of the opinion, and I can't say that I completely disagree, but some people are of the opinion that we shouldn't give Greg any attention because it's all he wants. But I agree that that's what he wants. But people need to know about what the fuck he's doing. People need to be informed about his shit. And, you know, he needs to face something, some kind of fucking repercussions for that, you know? I don't know. So, I'm okay with talking about him insofar as people are a little more aware of what he's, like, up to. Because it's pretty creepy. And he's preying on his fans. I mean, people know that. His whole support group thing is, like, his Discord now. I don't know. It's just, it's pretty creepy. It's pretty fucked. Let's see. What do we got here?
Choose love, not hate. Let's fuck.
Hang on. Where the fuck? No, hang on. We need to get this perfect. There you go. Choose love, not hate. Let's fuck. Just go to jail already. And that's perfect. And that's perfect. Okay, now we're slowly running out of Daddy Dom on Main tweets. We've still got some. I asked Vincent if I could interview Chris. I have a lot of questions about the numerous accusations against him. Would be a relief. So apparently Chris wanted to interview Greg for months now and has offered multiple times to have him talk on his show or whatever, on his channel. And Greg has declined every time because he's, because he just wants to have everything be on his terms, you know, because that's the only way it's fair, obviously. And apparently he wants to interview Chris now. So that's interesting. Chris is definitely the one people want to hear from at this point in time. We're really going to focus on his, like, personal life at this point. I'm pretty sure the person that he cheated on his wife with or whatever, pretty sure she was an adult. So, I mean, I think he's got one up on you. I don't know. Call me crazy. Let's see here. What is this?
I'm at the point where I refuse to be alone in a room with a woman because I know they can say anything they want about you and ruin your life.
Oh my god, just go to jail already. Hey, as long as he's not alone in a room with a woman, that's the important thing. That is the important thing here. Douchebag. Prince is cringing in his grave. He cheated so many times. That tweet just proves his fragile ego. He'll not be alone with a woman, but with a girl. Fax machine, everybody. Let's see. What's this one?
Don't ask why you should live. Ask what good there is in dying. None. So live, you goofball. I see people who stay in the good graces of society become boring and disappear, like they never existed. Hard to envy that, like a flower that only lived for a day. Fame often has no value. It can be a tool, but worthless if not used properly.
So this is from Onision Prime once again. So is this one here. These are from his secret private account. Very exciting stuff, everybody. We're not supposed to see these tweets, but they've been released by freedom fighters from the inside. Even his tiny inner circle. I don't know if you saw, I closed the window, but if you look at Onision Prime on Twitter, he's got like 100-something followers. So even like his tiniest, most, he has like millions of subscribers and he's only got about a hundred people that want to actually like talk to him. Which is 100 people too many. But yeah, it's, This is the secret account. This is the kind of edgy emo stuff that's happening in the secret account. It's probably a good thing we can't see it, honestly. What's this one?
Night. New Year's resolutions? What do you do that's kind of bad but really fun? I make messed up jokes.
Yeah, that's the fun, bad thing that you do, Greg. You're right. That's the only thing. That's the only thing I can think of.
Someone acted like I'm special for staying active online despite rejection from society. Society, everybody! Bro, I've always been an outcast. I was born in darkness, molded by it. Ha, Bane.
Somebody page Fuzu. Somebody get Fuzu on the line. Greg's using his holy name in vain. He's using the Bane name in vain. That's fun to say. Oh, jeez. Good fucking loop on that music. Aaron, hang on. We're looking for more music. Hold the fort. Hold the fucking fort. What do we got here? We did Crystal Chronicles last stream. I should do some Metroid Prime this stream. Yeah, that works. That fucking works. Please excuse. We're just busy adding some music. We gotta get the mood set, you know? Alright, that should be good for now. So, what's next? Well, we got some more Twitter stuff here. What's this one? So this is more from Onision Prime.
Life is sometimes seemingly limitless, kind of blown away by the universe. Life can be so good. Seriously, look for the good things in it. Morning, what are you doing to make yourself happier today? Hope you like the freak out bloopers. Heart emoji.
I hope you fucking did something when your daughter was having a brain injury. Hearts emoji. This is just such, like, look at this fucking avatar that he has got. Look at this absolute, like, Paul Zimmer-ass fuckboy avatar in this picture. Look at this shit. This man is closer to 40 than 30. Look at that fucking avatar. Is that not the most disgusting thing? Heart emoji, colon 3, Trumer. Who is Paul Zimmer? How dare you? Oh, right. I mean, what's his new name? Shit. I forgot Paul Zimmer's new name. God damn it. Emo gothic shit. Look at this dude! Play some Justin RPG. Seems like he stopped developing at 17. I actually had a theory about that, to be honest, where I had speculated that Greg, something must have happened to him where he just mentally, he never developed past the age of like high school. Some nebulous point in high school between like 14 and 17, probably on the younger end, where he just never got past. He has that same like teen arrogance. He doesn't seem to realize that 14-year-olds are off the table for him. He like, you know, he wrote those fucking books. It's quite something with Greg. I really do believe that he is in a lot of ways like mentally stunted. Again, I'm not a psychologist, but I do believe that there's some kind of like that. I think that has to be what it is. It's not even that he's like super, I don't know, all of the disorders that people like to throw around with him. I think he might be, you know, a sociopath or something like that, but I think it's more just that he's a fucking teenager in a grown-ass, ugly old man's body. I mean, not a bully stream. He's a teenager in a grown man's body. He's mentally, penis-wise, you know, so, yeah. Yeah, and, you know, the way he takes pictures, lest we all fucking forget. This stupid fucking, I already have it here, but the stupid fucking picture. Lest we all forget our boy. Taking pictures like this while he's busy being investigated by the feds. That's a wonderful look, you know? Wonderful look. What's this one?
You are my only comment section, so did you like today's Speaks video? Marilyn Monroe is so beautiful. Tonight is interesting, finding new things that are old. You know, you forget them now, so they feel new.
Like your daughter, yeah. Wow, she grew up so much, she's almost old enough for the fucking. Sorry, that's a bad joke, you know? That's a bad joke, but it is just a joke and definitely not an allegation.
I miss watching Sue.
Oh, you fucking would. And then we can't see the last one, sadly. But yeah, these are some looks into the Onision Prime world of secret tweets that we can't see. Good night. Ha ha. Ha ha. Oh, what is this? Oh, I miss I sometimes do dishes. Oh, yeah. Seduce someone in four words. You know, I sometimes do dishes, seduce someone in four words. That is a much better tweet than all of his weird daddy dom on main shit. That's a whole lot more palatable than that. What is this? Searches Eddie Vedder. YouTuber 1 reacts to Eddie Vedder, and then it's a bunch of... Okay, so... So most of his Onision Prime account seems to just not be talking about all the weird shit. Oh, here's one. He's been in pain for days, everybody. He's having trouble breathing. And this is on the 20th. The day that, like... This was, like, right around the same time that the news dropped about his daughter falling out the fucking window. Don't worry, though, guys. He's the one that's in pain. He's having trouble breathing. Guys, don't you feel bad? Yes, this is recent. This is, like, literally 2 days ago, you know? He needs to get the Glock. Have you ever heard the tale of Onion Man the Wise? What's this tweet? Oh, God. I thought we were done with this. Jesus Christ. Okay.
I want to ride you unprotected. I want to see your eyes quiver as you realize I just made you a mommy. I want to ride you unprotected.
Same fucking tweet again. Okay.
I want to see your eyes as you realize you become a mom. I know you don't talk to me expecting I'll listen.
Oh yeah, these are the tweets he was fucking sending while his daughter was in intensive care, everybody. These ones apparently line up with the time listed in that report that we read earlier. These apparently line up with when she would have been in the hospital for that. So he was busy tweeting about
the real reason you open your mouth toward me so often is in hopes that at least once you'll catch my cum. So keep pretending you mean anything you say. I'm almost there, my little slut. Doggy it is, slut.
This is him responding to himself. This man's. The state of this man's. Okay. Well, that was more important than his daughter and being, you know, it's fine. She's going to be, they'll take care of her. The doctors, they'll probably take care of her. It's fine. He's got important tweets to send, you know? Who finds this arousing? Well, I mean, some people, but not if it's fucking Greg. Self-induced doggy. This cured my porn addiction. While your daughter is in the hospital. Yes. Okay, Clooner. Okay, Groomer. Let's see here. What do we got? What's this one? This one could be fun. Oh, boy.
Don't be upset with anyone who trash talks me. I'd be pissed too if I wasn't allowed to fuck me. Please swish a cube of ice around your mouth before you put it on me again. Your spicy tongue is making me throb. Thanks, babe. There are 10 $1 slots left on Patreon. Then they're gone. It's basically the cheapest way to get access to an assortment of wonder and awe. You got a lot of spicy things to say about me with that mouth of yours. I wish you'd drop to your knees and show me what your tongue can really do.
How you guys feeling, chat? You ready to coom? Stop, 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 stop. Wonder and awe. I am eating, dude. Hey, listen, you should have known what was coming. You should have known what was cooming. Greg equals mega virgin confirmed. Well, that's the weirdest part. He has that big incel energy, but yet somehow he's got like multiple fucking exes and skeletons in his closet and people that he's lived with and shit. So that's weird. It's very weird. That's like, again, it's the kind of thing you feel like somebody would grow out of. The kind of like mindset, but I don't know. What is this shit? Oh, God. 2019 in 5 words.
Moaning, choking, fucking, and impregnation. Let's not fight. Let's get a baby in you.
That's enough of that on screen. That is quite enough of that on screen. Is this the same one? Oh no.
I have always been an amazing person. How dare you bully me? Bullies! I have feelies!
I have feelies! Don't bully me!
Guys, he has feelings. He has feelings, guys. He's just lucky his daughter still does. I hate this 40-year-old, says chat member. Bullies, nigga, you are 40. That's what a chat member said. Don't cancel me. I'm just reading the words on the screen. Don't be that asshole. Fuck this prick. Once again, chat member. What's this one? Oh, this one's tiny. Tiny boys.
Lucifer hated God because he was desperate for God's love, and God loved humans more than him. So Lucifer waged war on God. This is why I am God.
He's God, everybody. Amazing person.
I know I said it. It was a word in chat. Fuck you. I said it in videos before. Go check out the Tile Patterns Guy video. It's a classic. Let's see.
What is this one? Oh, yeah, this is the extended cut of that. This is one that also includes a video from Ready to Glare, which is kind of ironic. Life has taught me almost everyone is a liar. Fortunately, the closest I come to lying is in my acting, which basically makes me one of the greatest guys on Earth.
He's one of the greatest guys on Earth, everybody. You know him well. He's finally back to groom some tail.
This is wonderful. So, I don't know. We've got some more stuff here. I wouldn't want to miss anything. Have I missed anything? Oh, well, there's this one. This is a classic. And by classic, I mean I just saw this today and I loved it.
Greg, you should read the book. Okay, stop right there. Me reading books ended when I graduated high school, okay? Fuck you, Mom!
So this explains a lot, everybody. That explains quite a lot. Let me just lower that. We're just going to leave the bullies. I have feelings! Feelings! That explains his novels. Yeah. You sit on a throne of lies. Yes, he's written 3 books, and each one is worse than the last. I have only read parts of one, and it was the 3rd one because, again, it's the worst one, and it's pretty wonderful. Oh, people in chat are still mad because I read a chat message. It's you guys to blame, really. It's that was from the chat. It's all your fault. But do I have anything left here? I think I read all of these. Okay. Well, I think now is a good time to take a look at some more super chats, then. Let me go ahead. I have to delete like 1,000 fucking pictures now.
That's fine.
Clear that shit. We're gonna catch up on a few super chats here. We're going to return to the bear. And after this, we've got a few more things to read, but after this, we're gonna be looking at, I don't know, maybe secretly recorded Discord call with him and his gaggle of 12-year-olds on his Discord. That could be fun. We could also listen to his call to at 911. Always a good time. Let's see, where did I leave off? Was it Mark Mendez? Yes, we read that one. $5 from Danny A. What do you think will be the last straw for Onision to finally get arrested? I, you know, Good question. Very good question. He has done a lot of things that are legitimately, like, verifiably illegal. The copyright fraud is a big one. The wetlands thing is a big one. He's on fucking camera doing that. And then there's so much testimony about all of the other stuff. But even over and above the sex weirdo business, he's done some shit. So, yeah, I don't know. The days are numbered. Somebody in chat before said something to the effect of, I don't think Onision's leaving 2020 a free man. So, I mean, I don't know. This could be the final year of the Onion. Five euros from Soviet Onion. Onision, more like Ogrision. Oh, very, very good. $2 from Ryan Sweeney. Get on with it, Monty Python. Well, you know, I had to read the supers, but we got on with it. We read some lovely, lovely adult fan fiction, everybody. And you know, now we're back to this business. £5 from Lay's Daibo. The claw finally gets to shred some onions. Thanks for all the content, my dude. Well, thank you, sir. If you're not familiar, I do have a couple videos, three, in fact, where I talk about Onision. I have a couple past streams, too. I did read the third Onion book on stream, at least parts of it. £2 from Thwart Ass. Greg rhymes like he's the one with brain damage. Yes, I agree. If you've ever... I think the best example of him rhyming like someone with brain damage would be the video where he's standing on the poles and he's talking about, don't deny you love ice cream, you are perfect to the seam, and he's picking every word he can think of that, you know, fits with the scheme he's gone with. £3 from Sulfur and Honey. I'm really sick at the moment. This is what I needed. Thanks. $5 from Reaper 813. Every video of you talking about Onision should have a thumbnail of Banjo attacking an onion monster in the original game. You're right. I should go back and update a few of those. That's a good one. $2 from Buck Hammond. God, please, not the party cheese salad. Yeah, I mean, you're not the one that had to taste it. Someone in our Discord was threatening to make a party cheese salad yesterday. We had to talk them off the ledge. $2 from some Chinese things that I can't read. Rip Terry Jones, as well as Onision's career. Yes, I heard about Terry Jones. Very sad. Honestly, I thought everybody in Monty Python was already dead except for John Cleese, but you know, it's still very sad. $5 from Greek Fire Gaming. I only just heard about Onion Boy, but holy shit! Yeah, I was a late bloomer to Onision, too. I found out about him, like, last year. And I just binged a million videos making fun of his ass. And I was like, yeah, fuck this guy. And, yeah. $5 from Razzmatazz Bean. To be fair, he was diagnosed with things. Just like Kay's stuff. That's right. Kay had stuff, just like Greg has things that he's been diagnosed with. $2 from Kyle Newhouse. I read that he recorded his daughter after she fell. He did, indeed. Yes. That was in the official police report. According to him, he did it to ensure that the police didn't think that he was responsible or something. So that's cool. Recording your daughter before calling the police or the ambulance. That's very good. Very nice. $5 from Mae Madison. While it's on my mind, hot take, Irate Gamer made better content than Onion Boy. Quite the hot take. Somebody in the Discord also, last night, somebody found out that on fucking Irate Gamer's puppet channel, his toy puppet Steve channel, he had a fucking cameo from AVGN and Irate Gamer. I don't know, guys. That's apparently a video that he made with both fucking James Rolfe and the Irate Gamer character, which he's pretending is someone else. So that's very interesting. We might need to look at that at some point, but yeah. $5 from Colia Dante. Hello, police. I need a restraining order against Chris Hansen. Yeah, something like that. I'm sure that would go over perfectly well. $2 from Papa Shaw's.
He unyeeted her out of the window. Aww. Now, that's not fair. He was only criminally negligent. He didn't, well, as far as we know so far, he didn't actually do it himself, but that's certainly a theory people have had. $2 from Totally Not Connor. Do you think Onion is going to get smurfed in prison? Oh, I think he's going to get... I think they're going to smurf him long time, honestly. $2 from Cronoir. Or Cronoir? I'm not sure. Hashtag, I stand with Vic. No proof of what Vic is accused of. Well, somebody's making their stand. I don't know enough about the subject, but there you go. £2 from Nidamok. Onision, not very cash money. Yeah. After the shit we read, I think he's very un-cash money. I agree. $2 from Lola Ray. Petition to call Chris Hansen Christ Hansen. Well, like, let's not forget Chris Hansen's done some shit. Let's be fair. He has done some shit. But this could be his redemption arc. If he's the one to finally bring enough attention to Onision to get him, like, taken down, this can be his... This could mean a lot. $5 from Alex Swanson. After watching all content you have put out throughout all of 2019, I finally joined the Sicko Army yesterday. Worth it. Join the Sicko Army, folks. Well, thank you. It is worth it. Enlist today to the We're not the fastest growing army on YouTube. That's Greg. Don't look that up. Not this Greg, but Danny Gonzalez Greg. They're the truly Gregs. They're the fastest growing army on YouTube. But I think we're the most wholesome army on YouTube. We're the most interesting army on YouTube. You know, it's very exciting. And thank you for joining. The Sicko Army is pleased to have you. $3 from Bandicoot Thundersnatch. Make an Onision deleted tweet calendar. Yeah, you've got one for every day of the year, you know? It's like words of wisdom to live by about how he wants to fuck you. £2 from Out of Sight. Wait, I'm not a pedo, I'm baby. Yeah, pretty much he is baby. $5 from Cosmic Tube. Anti-transphobia. Pro-accomplice shaming. Kai needs... I think you meant accomplice. A Kai needs 15 to 30 years and petition for Onision party cheese salad scaffism. Yeah, I mean, that could be exciting. That could be... That is something I would like to watch. Finally, a video of Onision's that I would enjoy. £2 from Out of Sight. This snake thing calls for some do-re-me. I don't really know what that means, but he is quite the snake thing. $2 from Yours Truly Uber. Did a gravity bong hit before this. Let's go! Well, you know, on the spirit of the occasion, everybody. Because we all know that Greg hates smoking marijuana because it's against the law. And you'll need to tattoo yourself and chain yourself up in his basement to make up for it. Because we all know that Greg just hates marijuana so much. Let's smoke them if we got them, everybody.
Yo!
£2 from Out of Sight once again. He looks like Coomer Dante. I agree. As I've said before, he does look like bearded Dante from DMC5. He also looks like peak Coom. He looks like he's reached top Coom. $2 from Batman Anderson. What was Onion Boy's childhood like? Sup, Claw. Sup, Batman. I think it was probably not the best because apparently he fucking hates his dad and his dad beat him or something. So that probably led to a lot of stuff. Maybe he's got brain damage too and it explains everything. Maybe the daughter thing is the origin story of female Onision. Oh, that's rude. That's mean. But it is sad. It is very sad what happened to the daughter. And it only gets sadder if we as a society allow Greg to go unpunished for it. And Kai. Let's not erase Kai's fucking responsibility in all of this. Kai is just as fucking responsible for fucking criminal negligence. Man, Metroid Prime's soundtrack is so fucking dope.
right. We good. We gravy. $5 from Sir Wolfgang. It didn't just age like milk. I think he's talking about the tweet about fucking you by the window or whatever. It aged like milk left out on the counter on purpose. Oh, yes. Maybe next to some old stale mayo and a left out thing of ice cream turned upside down. Maybe you got a can of tuna left out, too. That's about how well that tweet aged. 420 from Camille Taggart. I think it was on purpose. Well, these are some spicy opinions. I don't know. It's not up to me to have opinions about things like that. That might not be fair use. But the chat certainly can. £5 from Thwart Ass. Tweet is from around the time daughter fell. And did you learn your lesson? $5 from Saber Bash, professional artist and lurker in Sicko Army. Where can I apply for shirt duty? Can send portfolio and stuff. Thanks for streaming and hope Greg dies. Well, that escalated quickly. As for where you can send portfolio and stuff, talk about it in the general homie discussion or maybe the art and selfies section. You can post some of your stuff on the Discord if you are on the Discord. Or maybe send me a DM. I'm pretty slow to respond to my messages, so just fair warning, but I'll get around to it. We're not talking about doing this immediately anyways. I gotta figure out how to get this all done and stuff. I'm pretty stupid when it comes to like merch and things like that, but I am interested in that eventually. Thank you for offering. $5 from Old Grandpap Diabetes. First I've ever sent a super chat at Chase versus Onision has prime tweets under the media tab. Want to see you read them. Also an unreacted version of, like unredacted version of the report. Chase versus Onision, huh? Okay, we're checking that out. Thank you for the heads up. Just enjoy the Super Metro or the Metroid Prime music for a minute. Mod at Chase Against Onision on Tumblr. Oh, fuck off. I need to sign in. Eat my entire ass. You can eat my whole asshole. Alright. Wow, 3,000 people are here. Welcome to the stream, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're enjoying yourselves. So here we are. Oh. This is very exciting. This is very exciting. Thank you. Wow. Where is the report? I don't see the report on here, but I'll look for it. But thank you very much for bringing this to my attention, Mr. Old Grandpap Diabetes. And thank you for the super chat. $2 from Totally Not Connor. POTUS has landed. Eyes on Breen. That's right. Anywhere Onision is in the country, POTUS needs to know. Eyes on Onision. $5 from ZZZZZZ. Thank you, Dr. Claw, for boosting my furry trash self-esteem by talking about actual trash people. Forging Kel Sarar in WoW tonight. Wish me luck. I have no idea what that means or if I said it correctly, but good luck and thank you. Maybe consider not being a furry, but that's your choice. $2 from Arinart. Gotta love that cursed Onision tweet ASMR. Ooh woo. Oh, it looks like we've officially coomed into the section of the super chats where people are saying, "Oh God, please no," because I was reading the sex tweets. Let's see. $2 from Meggie's. God has abandoned us. $2 from Louise Barbosa. Do more Valley Girl. Do more Valley Girl Onision. That's just the way he sounds. That's just kind of the way he is. I don't know, but $20 or 20 sec from Pella or Pella. Imagine how small his peepee is while reading this. Yeah, I mean, you know, baby carrot fam, stand strong. Strongest growing army, smallest growing army on YouTube. $10 from Goof Troop, say with a lisp. I'm gonna slap you, rawr. Oh, whoa. $5 from Razzmatazz Bean. I dislike this man. Thank you for doing all of my work for this stream for me. I could have just said that. I don't know why I even went to all this trouble. $2 from Luca. B has always hated Onion Boy for years and years. Yeah, for good fucking reason. Because Onision is like 2008 B. Like, asshole B. Onision's like RAR XD in present day, and it's weird. $2 from Camille Taggart. Fuck toys are such easy prey. That's only hot when it doesn't involve Onision. And it does involve consent. $2 from Joseph De Leon. Onion bitch and snake both killed my boner, chief. Yeah, this might have been a bit more difficult for some people than the snake thing stream. $5 from Christ724. Carry my seed and drop it from the second floor. Onision. Ooh, that one cuts deep. $2 from Greasy Sauce. He's going to be doing a lot of toe touching in jail. Yeah. Well, we can only hope. $5 from Jordan Sutherland. I'm hungover, and this is making me feel better and worse at the same time. Well, you know what? If you wind up needing to vomit because of Greg's tweets, you should just let it all out. It's a natural process, you know? It's probably important. $2 from Nathaniel Fox. My YouTube crashed. It couldn't handle the kringe. Understandable. Johnny Onision is pretty kringe. Colia Dante, $5. There's a fetish where people are into trans men, women to men, who haven't had bottom surgery, and it sounds like Greg has it. Yes, there is, again, a pattern of him like habitually defeminizing his spouses and shaving their heads and making them wear men's clothes and things like that. And so, I don't know. I feel like that, coupled with the way Kai was like 15 when they fucking met, I don't know. It raises some questions about some things, but, you know, I'll let you guys fucking argue that one out. Kai is the ultimate case of it's unfortunate that this happened to you, but also you're a fucking scumbag in your own right, so fuck off. We need some more music. We're doing, like, the whole fucking Metroid Prime 2 soundtrack, too. It's fine. This is a perfect... Because I'm not editing this stream down into a video. I'm not cutting this down into a video. This is a good stream for just, like, chilling out and, like, listening to some tunes. The Metroid Prime music is the only way I'm going to be able to get through this, you know? Get in some Sanctuary Fortress. That's good. All right, we're all set to go, then, for music. Let's see. $2 from Strix Nebulosa. Let's all ride in Greg's best friend free candy van. Yeah, it's free candy, everybody. It's fine. It's going to be fine. $10 from Mint Solstice. And as a hardcore lesbian, you get an F card pass on this degenerate. I know I used the other word, but did I call him an F card? I don't know if I did, but I'll keep that in mind. Thank you. $2 from Romantic Outlaw. When your icon pops up over Greg's on tweets, it's great. Yeah, that kept happening. That kept happening. $2 from Daniel McCoy. When you going to snort helium in herbs? I've been thinking about doing another herb stream. I did one like a year ago or some shit, and I played as Mr. and Mrs. Obama, the Ronald McDonald lookalike clown man. And then the stream kind of went to shit because my old computer was bad. But I think I can do a Game Boy Advance game now. I think that could work. £5 from Thwart Ass. The mother of Greg's kids is the one that fucks a pussy. Yeah, that's true. That's true. That makes a lot of sense. $10 from I Don't Care. Using Vancid instead of YouTube. So no more ad revenue for me, Clawfather. But here's 10 bones still. Tear Mr. Bend over Mr. Ogre a new one. Mr. Ogre, huh? Well, that's okay. That's okay. You can move on to whatever Vancid is. I'm sure they'll get shut down in a week, but... thank you. People have actually said I should consider moving my shit to another site. Like, someone was saying Vidly or something last night, and I'm like... Nobody in the call has heard of this. I've never heard of this. People think it sounds like Bitly. I don't know if I'm going to have quite the future on there, but, you know, I'll consider it, maybe. $10 from Captain Above, Gregory Groomery Jackson. That's good. That's a very good one. $5 from Lola Ray. Even my perpetrator, when I was 8, got shanked to death in jail. Onion has no hope, Lamau. Best start resizing your holes on your own, oh stinky on. Oh, damn. That is some scathing energy in that tweet. Well, thank you. $2 from Dolphin TM. Claw, your music choice is always a prime pick. Ah, you know, more so than ever. Thank you. $10 from Swamp Dweller. This is an onion even Shrek wouldn't touch. Oh, you're fucking right. 100 rubles from Inconsistent Buttface. Unrelated to anything, but what's your opinion on an infected mushroom? Been wondering this for a while, but only remembered to ask now. Oops. I have heard of them, but I don't know anything about them, and I don't even remember what I heard about them, how I heard about them, and what it was in relation to. I don't know, but I think they're like electronica or something. Aren't they from Israel? I'm not sure, but I think I might look into them someday. €5 from Endurement Hase, and no message. I'm probably saying your name wrong, so sorry. Fiery One with $5. Look, I got breeding fetish, and even hearing Onision say he wants to make someone a mommy makes me want to vomit. I mean, you know, don't fucking tell anybody, but I might have had a couple of things ruined for me reading those tweets. But, you know, £2 from Nidamok. Think of the children, SpongeBob. Think of the children. Not like that, though, Greg. 149 rubles from Lissa Bonfox. Thanks. Now I need a shower. Sorry. But thank you. $5 from Ethan Cussett, or Cussat. Reading his Twitter gives me the same feeling as biting into an actual raw onion. I now understand the name. $2 from Bubby Boy. Much love from Korea. You're a much better mediker. Oh, I wouldn't say that necessarily, but I think I do very different stuff, honestly. People make the comparisons, and I guess they're similar. We do similar kinds of things, but it's very different stuff. Different style, at least. But thank you. And finally, for now, at least, we got $5 from Leo the Bum Tickler, who says, "Ooh, Bear Boy said the N-word. It was a quote from chat, okay? It's you guys' fault. It was just a soft day. It was fine. It was totally fine. And honestly, I've been given the pass by like 9 people now, and it's Greg. Come on, it's fine. I can read a chat message. I think that's okay. So we're going to move on for now. We're gonna continue with some more things. Now, what should we continue with? I guess, firstly, I'd like to bring up this guy. This dude named... I forget his name. Steven, I think. A Sark. And he's, like, trying to email Greg. He's, like... I think he's a reporter for Newsweek, if I'm not mistaken. And he was he did a story on Greg. He did a story on Onision. And I guess he tried to get in contact with him. And so what follows is like a 9 email chain of him communicating with the office of Onision Incorporated or whatever the fuck. And what we got is, here's my official statement. A lot of people are making money off of this. A lot of people are motivated by money and peer pressure. There are crimes happening all over the world right now. These same people do not care about crimes. What people care about is money and attention. I do not want to participate in this circus without compensation. I should be paid to endure to stupidity of the current state of outrage/online culture. So apparently that's Greg's official statement. Now, I think some parts of this message this conversation are missing, but this is the Onision management, everybody. You are an authentic journalist who would not publish gossip and slander, so there should be nothing for me to say. Well, I think that article did come out, and it wasn't gossip and slander. It was like actual quotes that were attributable. Let's see. Not reading it. The link alone shows you are totally ignorant. What an idiot. So apparently the headline of the article, maybe, that this guy wrote was like a little bit inflammatory in so much as it said what Greg has done and told the news. But Greg didn't like this, and he says that he's an idiot because of it. So we got this one.
You clearly inserted your own opinion in the URL alone. That's not honest journalism. Additionally, I gave you only information outside NDAs. You having any opinion is ridiculous, especially as a reporter, because of how little you actually know. Bad reporting. Very, very unprofessional. They're treating me very badly. Alright? Very badly.
Let's see here. Number 5.
Yuck. Amazing how incapable people are of accepting rejection.
I'm so confused, says Steven Asarch. I just sent you the link. Nobody is getting rejected. You're spending Christmas sending mean messages for what exactly? So yes, this was happening on Christmas Day. Onision was like arguing with this man who was writing an article about what a weirdo he is, allegedly. And it just keeps getting kind of worse for him, honestly.
Here's a fact. I have the last person who dumped me was the person I married to. If I did not reject other people in my life, they would still be with me. The entire anti-Onision campaign is a massive, pathetic joke.
It's all a hoax. It's just a witch hunt. It's just a fake hoax.
Rejection is the only reason anyone is after me. Like a guy who tells everyone a girl is a slut for not putting out. You and everyone else are ignoring the obvious motive.
This is a good one. This is a peak Onision message, because I mean, like, yes, there's a motive for people to come out against him. Like, sure, there's a motive. I have a motive for streaming about him because people watch, and because there's like 3,000 people here right now, and because it's you know, his name is relevant because of what a piece of scum he is. But this is a wonderful tweet because, like, or what, rather not a, even a tweet. This is a private correspondence with a reporter. This is a wonderful email from Greg because it's like, it really shows the mental state as it's like fracturing, and this weird like narrative that he's got going on. But more importantly, it's like, he talks about the obvious motive, and yeah, again, there's motive for people to do it, to talk about him, to out him, to do whatever. But there's also verified proof of things that you've done that are illegal. So I think that kind of trumps anything else, you know? I think that kind of says a lot. I don't know, but I guess that's less important than the fact that some people could be making money off of this, which he is also by stealing people's video revenue. So, I mean, you think he would be all on board. I guess he's just upset that this guy's publishing an article that he can't steal the revenue from, like he does with YouTube. I get why Trump hates the media, says Onision. Y'all have no life experience and couldn't detect a lie if it smelled like shit and was shoved up your nose. All you see is what would make the best headline. Sellouts. Sellouts, everybody. This guy's a sellout for wanting to tell the facts about, like, again, there's, like, again, verifiable messages between him and, like, underage girls and his fucking spouse and underage girls. I'm not sure how that's not... I'm not sure how that's not, like, more important than this, you know? Onision's getting Chris Chan levels of paranoid towards haters, says chat member. Onision to a 4-year-old. Take some responsibility! Mert03 says, I need to bang someone's wife. Anal sex with 2 X's. I agree. I'm also I'm also open for that. DM me. But yeah, so... What's happening with the divorce, asks the reporter. You are an idiot. And note that we're now on James Jackson here. The new fake name that he's assumed, by the way, because Greg is, like, I guess a loaded name. I don't know. James Jackson. Why? Just a question. And James responds, again, James and not Onision Management. But James responds, the fact that you don't know why you were an idiot for asking that really shows how much of an idiot you are. Please do not contact me again. Ah, the classic. If you don't know, I won't tell you. That's always good. People love that. So, yeah, I think that's it for the Steven Asark or Asarch emails. That's very interesting. Because we know how he is in public with Twitter, but the way he acts privately with this reporter who's running a story that's going to tell a lot of people about his shit, it's very fractured and fearful. No basement for smoking weed. It's one of his self-insert names. Yes, that's right. James, I believe, is the name of the character from the second book, if I'm not mistaken. Or might be the third book. I forget. But, yeah. One, and it's another one of his OCs. Onision movie about his trial when... You know, that could be exciting. I remember Fred mentioned when we were talking about Wolf on stream... Frederick Knudsen, he said, like, I said, when are you going to do a down the rabbit hole about Onision? And he was like, there's no through line. There's no way to make him a good protagonist because it's just Onision fucks someone over. Onision fucks someone over. Onision ruins someone's life. Onision fucks some. It's just like this ongoing. It's like serial more than anything. We need an Ace Attorney style Onision case, Lamau. We've got somebody in chat named XXX Amateur Sex Videos. Click here. That's my favorite chat member. So, let's see. What should we do next? I guess we should probably do this. Oh, find my fucking window, you whore. Fucking hell. Fuck it out. Technical difficulties. There you go. So here we are on Chase versus Onision. An account which apparently has a lot of interesting stuff from Greg from Onision Prime. First of all, look at this man's fucking face. Look at this haircut. Look at everything about this selfie right here. Am I muted? No, I don't think I'm muted, you fuck. Here we go again. Sitcom laugh track. Unmute myself. Oh, that's cool. Final Fantasy looking ass. Where he chin? Well, it's cut off by the picture. But why he hair? Why he hair? Why he eyes and that, like, weird, like snake thing cocked smile? You know what I mean? Fucking no. Ew. Why are his eyes so big? He's Light Yagami. You want to match his women in age. Pasta hair. Yeah, something like that. But what do we actually got here? Hope you have a good night. He's scheduling a movie around some person, one of his 15-year-old fans. It's interesting when you finally win but have lost the ability to care. Onision's winning, everybody. It's interesting to me how he seems to show no fucking emotion whatsoever to his daughter, like, falling out of a window. He's still doing... He's just exactly the same on Twitter. He's doing the exact same shit. He's just talking in the exact same manner. He's really very... It's, like, emotionless. It's like... You know the guy that John Lithgow played in Dexter? The dude who had, like, the wife and the kids and everything? It's that kind of shit, where it's just, like... They're just... They're basically, like, expendable to him, aren't they? He just doesn't give a shit. He just continues on taking fuckboy, you know, 14-year-old selfies and shit. He just... Wow. It's just incredible. An actual sociopath. He has no empathy. Yeah. Is he in jail yet? Jesus. He will be. Eventually. I don't think there's much chance of him staying out, honestly. Oh, here's the whole picture. Here's the full thing. Isn't he so cute, guys? Look at how cute he is. Don't you guys find him, like, adorable? Isn't he just adorbs? I joined the chat to see this. His hair is photoshopped on. What the fuck is this? He just wants to live a quiet life. Final Fantasy looking ass once again. Yes. Onision Prime's tweets part 20. Please try the Beyond Meat products at Carl's Jr. Plant-based awesomeness. So remember, everybody, the next time you encounter a vegetarian, just be careful. Exclusively tweeting here now. Thanks for existing. Such a great character. Chibi at night. What is this fucking shit? What is this disgusting shit? Okay, a lot of these are unfortunately gone. That sucks. Did he content claim this guy's tweets or something? What the fuck? That's weird. Someone posed as one of you trying to get access. Oof. Uh, 2016 was the end of non-family friendly content on YouTube. 2020 is the end of family friendly content on YouTube. And then we got some, like, Smash Mouth. So this is a very boring account. There's not that much of interest here. Are we watching The Mandalorian? We have a thing on Discord. Like, make toy videos and cancel each other. Oh, he found out about Puppet Steve just when we did. What, wasn't the handshake thing just them being polite and shaking the wife's hand? Okay. So, yeah, again, these are pretty boring. These are boring tweets. These aren't as interesting as his main account. I think my main Twitter and recent chapters have given people the idea that I'm willing to have similar private conversations. I just don't have the interest. I think I'm kind of broken inside and just see everyone as someone who could never really care for me. Oh, fuck off. He's just so broken, guys.
He's damaged. Guys, he's damaged. He needs to get a tattoo on his forehead that mentions that he's damaged. Because he's so damaged.
He'd shoot himself by accident. How does he get ratioed on every single fucking tweet?
Crawling in my skin.
So yeah, this is a little bit lame. So he's telling someone to leave the Patreon. Okay, somebody snuck into his Patreon. Sorry for the extended silence, I was just reading. Somebody snuck into his Patreon, I guess. You ugly fucking predatory fuck. Lying is wrong! So all you really did here was pay me just to establish that you're a liar. Bye. Well, no, it was to get access to your weird fucking, like, sex doll content or whatever.
I want your dick, though.
No, no. Uh-huh. I'm better for you, and you know it. So there's a lot of people trying to, like, pretend to be, like, Onision fans. That's good. That's very good. But, yeah, this Twitter is not really as exciting as, not really as exciting as his main Twitter, sadly. Let me just... There you go. This is not really as exciting as his main Twitter. He's very downbeat here. Not that interesting, you know? More pretend fans than real ones. Yeah. I think there's probably more... what's up with the sex accounts? Oh, is Onision, like, spamming the chat with, like, okay. Is that what's happening here?
Huh. Who would sneak into his Patreon? Chase owns Onision's house. Have you heard the Discord call recording where he went to garner pity from his fans and all you can hear is the voices of teenage girls? Well, funny you should mention that. We might just be about to go and listen to that right now, as a matter of fact. Right this very second. Bring the music to an end here.
I've been told repeatedly to not even bother.
So here's Greg and his fan base on YouTube, or on Discord rather, talking, and I guess he's trying to get pity or something. So let's listen to the voices of his fans, everybody.
And you don't engage, they just say you're guilty.
Well, either way, you're guilty. Apparently.
Oh, the volume. Hang on. There you go.
Yeah, if you do go on,
you're guilty. You don't go on, you're still guilty.
Oh, that's never gonna happen. Here's the thing. I'm not gonna go on someone's show who literally.
Is going to make
a buck so he can pay off a $60,000 American Express bill. You guys noticed they didn't post the footage of what he said, what he was yelling into my house.
What did he yell?
Oh, what did he yell?
He was like
he yelled maybe 15 different things.
What did he say?
Like what kind of things?
Now's the time to talk. If you want to meet somewhere else, you should let me know. I know you're in there, Kai.
Why did he come to your house? That's so weird.
Allegedly, he followed another person with a child home. I don't know. There is one fact. There's a lot of lying going on. Because nobody followed me because I was home all the time. Like, the only place you would follow me is places you shouldn't follow me, which is, like, really personal places that have nothing to do with anything except for, you know, keeping people safe. So I don't know why you're following me to any, you know, like let's say I went to a family function, okay? If you're following me to a family function, you're a fucking creep, you know?
Yeah, that's really creepy. What the fuck?
So,
has that happened?
Essentially. Essentially, yeah.
Oh my God, the motherfucker showed up at his house. What the fuck, man?
Oh, but
Gabe says that Chris Hansen uploaded a video of him at his door, so we might want to look into that. But I don't know if I want to be copyright claimed by fucking Vincent. Can we just talk briefly about how that fucking human orc is going to ruin everything? Can we just briefly bring up what a fucking clown Vincent
McCaughtry
is?
You guys should be excited.
Okay.
I'm about to release the bloopers from all my freakout videos.
Can I ask you about a white elephant in the room?
What?
Go ahead.
What?
Yeah.
I'm right here, dude.
Twitch.
Oh, yeah.
That was just because he was streaming also, though.
I wasn't streaming.
Well, no, they said that you got banned because you used other sites to stream and you weren't supposed to do that or something.
Yeah, which I tried to tell you multiple times.
Violates the terms of...
But I didn't get viewers there anyway.
It doesn't matter. Twitch is like, you either conform to our standards or you do nothing.
Yeah, it made me glad that I didn't invest in Twitch just because, like, if they're going to ban you over, like, streaming on multiple platforms, they can go fuck their mothers. Hey, where
wine sauce? No.
What are these,
you're right. I can't believe you stooped so low.
Lawyer, dude.
Oh, I actually am not really.
Like this guy. Actually, they're like,
of his,
like even with Vincent, the guy that's working or with Chris.
Someone in chat is suggesting that James. Greg. Sorry, we want to use his real name, not his fake name. Should check out the song "Little Girls" by Oingo Boingo. I would also suggest "Jailbait" by Wishbone Ash.
Hansen, there's like. All sorts of allegations on him too. And like,
why is everyone who works with the guy have some kind of sex thing going on?
Says a lot about.
Why are they all sex weirdos?
Well, apparently, if you don't answer your door for a creep, that says a lot about you. He's very familiar with the police.
On the one hand, can you fucking imagine if these people are actually, like, legitimately his fans? People on Twitter have been saying, I think Onision unprivated and some of the people that she was retweeting were saying, like, his fan base is not just tiny kids. There's also adults. There's also adults with children. And it's kind of like a Daddy-O-5 situation where it's like these similarly fucked up people kind of collide and become... They become a, you know, someone will become a fan of this person who's doing fucked up weird shit because they also kind of are like into all that fucked up weird shit, you know. That's what some people
fucking
say.
Mugshot. Okay, that's ridiculous. You know why I have a lot of history with the police? Because I'm constantly calling them on people.
I don't doubt it.
That's terrible.
Yeah, one of the people on his show, I called the cops on twice.
Also, he was like, he must be pretty.
And the second, and the second time, the cops literally hauled them away, and took him to a literal mental asylum or whatever.
Paranoid.
That's a guest. That's a literal guest of the Hansen thing. Is a person who got hauled away to the mental asylum because they called the cops on them. So okay.
Let's just like analyze the situation. This is a man who's got Chris Hansen coming to his door to talk about what a creepy weirdo he is, who's trying to go and solicit like pity from 15-year-olds. And, like, just keep that in, like, his whole thing right now is, well, people kill themselves when he talks to them. Yeah, because they're fucking being shamed for being creepy weirdos. Why do you think that happens, Greg? What the fuck? What point are you trying to make?
It doesn't, you're talking about pathological lying on a constant basis, being constantly called out for it and proven in the past, and it's being ignored now. And now everything they say is credible. And it's like, guys, look at the police reports, okay? Look at the police reports. Nobody seems to live in reality.
Look at that.
I'm not gonna stream my league stuff or any stuff for a while because I don't really want to like populate this place more, and I also don't want controversy.
Oh, did a whole bunch of new people like. Now pay more?
Yeah. What?
I don't know.
Well, at the same time, YouTube takes a big cut. Do you guys know what it's like to be so famous that you have to wear sunglasses wherever you go?
No. Sorry, sir.
I literally.
Did one of them just say sorry, sir?
I literally went somewhere. I didn't wear my disguise. And I get spotted again, and I'm like, fuck, I thought I could take it off, and I couldn't, just because, like, and they're like, tee-hee-hee, that's Onision, like, audibly, very loudly saying it, and I'm just like, Jesus Christ, and I'm so, like, bad famous, too, not good famous, so it sucks double.
Infamous.
Yeah, like,
infamous.
Oh my fucking god, is he a Dairy Queen? You know, that kind of famous.
Oh my gosh, I remember that. That was...
It's fucking disgusting, bro.
Yeah, because your kids were in that. Why would you film someone that they're with their children? That's just weird.
I don't have children. Shut up.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, he doesn't have a third spouse.
The bonds don't exist.
I was renting it to look good for the...
Okay.
Renting
I was like, look at me. You can relate to me now. I'm a person.
You were renting Kai?
What was he talking about, the dude talking about when he said he's going to get you an inside look at the house of Onision? What was that?
What was that?
Maybe he was like...
People were theorizing... Shut up, no murder. People were theorizing that my house was tapped or something. You know what would be a really fucked up video for me to make is me coming out as a trans woman.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus that would Christ. Be you would trigger so many people.
I'd just be the Trisha Paytas version of it.
Yeah. Oh, God. Okay. He's going to trigger so many people, guys. He's going to trigger all the leftists. The liberals are going to get told, everybody. Yeah, so... cancel out some of these bad boys. So... That was the leaked Discord call. A lot of children, or at least very young sounding like women. Probably most of the people there, I would say, are like spies. Let's be honest. Most of them are spies. Most of them are, like, secret, like, freedom fighters. Does that mean we can call him Onion Yaniv, too?
I'm famous, Uwu.
Yeah, he's famous, guys. He's super fucking famous. Don't worry, dude. Chris Hansen's gonna make you real famous. Beating the libs through pedophilia. Oh, and I thought the libs liked pedophilia. Oh, that's a joke. That's a joke, everybody. So, what should we do next? How about the, okay, I've got a double feature here. We can compare and contrast. Hang on. So we got a transcript of the 911 call. Some of this is, like, the 911 call, a lot of this stuff is, like, you know, old news to some extent, you know what I mean? Like the 911 thing, the Chris Hansen thing happened, like, last week or whatever, a couple weeks ago. You know, I feel like this is the last time, at least for quite a while, anyway, that I'm probably going to be talking about Greg. And in just a general-ass call to action about what a fucking psycho weirdo this man is. Not a bully stream, but Jesus Christ. If it was ever going to be a bully stream, now would probably be a good time for it, because this man needs to be behind bars. He has done things that are verifiably illegal. And he's finally taking some fucking... He's finally getting close to being dealt with for that. So, I mean, that's a little bit exciting. But, as I say, we've got the double feature here of a... Oh, hang on. Let me get this up. And let me do this. There you go. That's what you need to do. And head over to this one. Take this. Wrong one. Oh, fuck. Okay. Oh, god damn it. Thank you, OBS, for being such a wonderful experience. Just such a wonderful streaming experience with OBS. It's just so smooth. It is just so buttery, liquid smooth. Okay, there you go. We've got the transcript of the 911 call. And we've got some new beautiful music, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Oh no. Oh no. Why does this fucking audio file have no audio? God damn it. Well, that's really lame. But okay, hang on. Fucking... Where is the... Is this gonna be with some jabroni talking over it?
Washington. We've been on his trail for the last day or so. He knows we want to talk to him. I knocked on the door. I heard his voice. I heard Kai. They called the sheriff's department. The deputy has now responded. He's been talking till now.
HRIS.
Okay, here we go. Okay, big thanks to Heartbeats Vanity, I guess, for this.
Just saw like six guys in my driveway, and one of them is knocking on my door.
Okay, 1 second here.
Typing and dog barking.
And the one that's knocking on your door, is he the main one that you said has been stalking you?
Uh-huh. Yeah, he's a stalker. Oh. He's yelling things at me through the door right now.
Such a stalker.
Okay,
this.
And what do we know his name at all?
It's Chris Hansen.
Okay, H-A-N-S-E-N?
H-A-S-E-N, yeah. H-A-N-S-E-N.
And then C-H-R-I-S?
C-H-R-I-S, yeah.
Okay, is he white, black, Asian, Hispanic?
At this point, the ladies...
Okay. Do we
at this point, there's like cogs spinning in this lady's brain. And she's like, wait a second, Chris Hansen. Okay. Well, she maybe not, because she keeps asking him for his description.
Like probably 58, 60, something like that. Probably 5'10", 5'11".
Okay.
It's Chris
then
Hansen,
medium or heavy?
Everybody.
He's skinnier.
We know what his name. Hair? It's Chris Hansen.
Blondish gray.
Okay, and are you able to see what he's wearing or no?
I think he's wearing a black jacket.
Okay.
I have a security camera.
Uh-huh. Can you see what color pants?
He's wearing a black jacket, black pants. His hair is gray. He's still yelling things at me through the door.
Okay, black jacket, black pants. Can you hear what he's yelling?
No.
Okay.
Oh, he's saying, I want your side of the story, Greg. My name's not even Greg.
My name's not even Greg, okay. Guys. It's not
what
even
is your
Greg.
Last name?
My name is James.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Last of first of James.
James Jackson, everybody.
Yeah, he's saying, I just want to talk through the door.
Okay. And what's your
name? I just want to have a seat over here.
November 11th.
November 11th of
8th? Yeah.
Okay. And what is your best callback number?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any weapons in the home, James?
No, I don't.
Isn't that not true? Doesn't he have guns?
And
isn't he a gun enthusiast?
There's roughly 5 more people there with cameras.
Yes, in the driveway.
Okay.
I just want to talk, Greg.
Second here.
He does. He does have weapons, doesn't he?
And do you know what he's talking about? Like, why he was stalking you or anything like that?
Yeah, there's like a... It looks like there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people in the driveway.
Okay.
But he... I have someone that I... There's an 18... No, I think they're 19. A 19-year-old who I didn't want to hang out with. I didn't want to be around them. They have BPD, and their stuff was, their mental disorder was, like, really affecting my life in a negative way. And so I said I didn't want them in my life anymore. And they went to...
No, this is Billy, right?
About me. And so now this person's trying to...
Or Shiloh?
Like, aggressively pursue me in a really hateful way as a result.
Okay, so you said they're from YouTube, though. So is it, like, a show that they do, or...?
It's a live stream. Yeah.
Oh, it's Shiloh.
I've already
Sarah?
Had a lawyer about
okay,
Amanda,
it's Sarah.
This guy's really, really hateful towards me.
Okay, so he's trying to pass off the fucking 14-year-old that he brought into his house with his spouse to groom for... ripe for fucking at the age of, like, 18 or whatever. He's trying to pass off that person as... just some 19-year-old, whatever. I didn't want them in my life anymore. Oh, that's cool. That's really
okay.
Cool. That's super cool.
And are you able to see what type of vehicle they arrived in?
No, they parked way down the street, which is really sketchy.
Okay.
They're standing out next to my SUV right now.
Okay. We're working on getting units out there as quickly as we can. Just go ahead and keep your doors locked. Do you feel comfortable disconnecting the line until we arrive? And then if anything changes, calling us back?
It should be fine.
Okay,
we're just hiding away from the windows.
Okay. If anything changes...
situation and given a play or anything like that...
I'm guessing the rest of this is just some commentary. Apparently there's more to the call, though. I'm calling back. I reported some people that showed up at my house. They're trespassing, and they're on my... What's the address? Has something changed on the scene? Just waiting for police to show up. They're still on my driveway. Okay, it is still snowing here on my screen, and law enforcement has been advised. Or still showing on my screen. Well, it could be snowing, too. You know, it's possible. It's that time of year. If anything does change or escalate, call us back. Anything escalates at all, call us back. Okay, so basically just, yeah, fuck off. Because it's not really anything. It's like, just, yeah, I hope nothing happens, I guess. It's fine. So, yeah, Chris Hansen came to the dude's house. Don't call Chris Hansen at 3 a.m., chat. He really came to my house. No crimes committed because he didn't say leave. What is with the fucking free porn accounts? Can you guys, like, not do this? Thanks. Aren't there any mods in chat? What the fuck? Anyways. So, yeah, that's, I don't know. Is there any more? Is there anything more to discuss? Oh, yeah, I guess we were going to talk about his cult. I don't know. I guess we could talk about his cult.
I guess we probably should talk about his cult, honestly. Yeah. Fuck it. Let's do the cult. Hang on. We need some music. We need some music. We can't get by without music. We gotta have a little bit of music in our life, you know? There you go. Alright, so we're gonna be looking into Onision's cult, everybody. You guys excited? How many of you guys know that we have, that Onision has a cult? I want everything about my sex crimes off the internet! Begone thought. Oh yeah, he had a cult. Cult, cult, cult. Cult music. Mods are homosexuals. Well, I mean, that guy said it, not me. Oh boy, Greg, has he got arrested yet? Not yet, but hopefully soon. Big Sisika, yes. This is the name of the cult, I believe. Sisika. Or Siseka. Sisika. I don't know how to pronounce it, but that's the name of the cult. And he started it in, like, 2005, I believe. And, it's some very interesting stuff. Scientology-esque, if you might allow me. I think he envisions himself as some sort of flying space spaghetti monster god or something. And there's a bunch of weird shit about women. I don't know. We're gonna look into that. Good song. Yeah. So, Onision's cult. Now, I think I had this bookmarked, if I'm not mistaken. Do I have this bookmarked? No, I don't think I have this. Okay. Well, give me a couple minutes to find it. I think somebody... Sekeska? Is that the name of it? Sekeska, I think, is what it's called. So we've got some archives here. Because the actual site for the cult is, like, down now. But there is this. I guess I'll just do a dramatic reading, because this is what we got. There is a site. Like I say, there is a site for Sekeska, the cult. But it's been taken down. It doesn't really have much to it outside of text. And there's a Tumblr here which has collected all of the text, or at least all the important stuff. So we're going to be taking a look here at onisiondrama.tumblr.com/Sekeska. And it's this long fucking document detailing all of Greg's weird, crazy space cult beliefs. I can't believe Onision crosses over with space cults. I can't fucking believe that my two passions, making fun of Greg and making fun of fucking Ashtar, are, like, colliding. This is a fantastic occasion. This is a red letter day. So yeah. Sekeska, welcome. The literary documents provided on this site introduce and evaluate an amazing reality which is now finding homes in millions of information-hungry minds all over the Earth. For the recorded years of humanity, one of the many questions before intrigued minds has revolved around the most important topic of all subjects. What is existence for? How do we exist? I'm gonna crank that up a little bit. Sekeska has become an answer to the vital questions concerning our lives through logical yet amazing facts involving the past and present world. Those capable of understanding Sekeska and the perspectives provided will find the key so many have been searching for. Today you have the opportunity to observe an alternative mentality, a path divided from the default standards evolving simple beliefs that have convinced most all one time or another. Existence is a seemingly complicated subject that so few have neared a proper conclusion to define beyond mere present time. Diversions through methods involving excuses such as downing human capabilities are oftentimes given freely to avoid confrontation of the reality at hand. We have the ability to expand ourselves, and here you will find out how true this statement really is. You have entered a new section of human comprehension. Those seeking a meaningful answer to settle what no system of beliefs has before will continue on through the pages our works has to offer.
all others visiting us today will continue their lives devoid of these rare perspectives. The choice is yours, Neo.
So this is some pretty edgy stuff so far. Isn't this the plot of Evangelion? This shit is great. You've gone into the crazy door.
I honestly find Onision's D&D cult campaign boring as fuck. Well, I don't know. I think there's some interesting stuff here about his psyche, at the very least. This explains his novels. Fax Machine Jackson is back at it. Please read it like a JRPG villain. From the center of our earth dwells a major power which keeps humanity in play while living out the lifespan remaining for its future. Proper respects are rarely given to a humble life source, like plants, water, and the soil we walk on. We once came. The earth we coomed! The earth once produced chemicals devising and manipulating the pre-human body to near perfection in order to create advanced creatures to one day defend our earth's very life.
This is literally the plot of FF7. Hang on, this music is perfect.
Unlike the apparent failure of other planets, our Earth created both soul and body to serve it with free will, while having our own individual lives to advance ourselves, while being the sons and daughters of the world we live in. Good nature toward others manifests also as a contribution to our planet, in a small or large portion. On all continents, different races and species were created based on the world's different inhabitants. And being created by different sections of one life form came different life form appearances and even alternate species. Since the time of birth, humans have created languages, cultures, and furthermore, mentalities. As time passes, the mentalities separate many from Earth while focusing more on self. Nearer to the first births of humans came a greater sense of respect for our planet as we relied on it while we were in turn given a sense of value beyond other planets. Assumingly destined to mutually contribute, the Earth continued to support our lives in significant portions. Since then, our planet has still not given up on us, as we are not yet failures of the cause.
So this keeps going on. The purpose of humans... And now we get into some of the weird shit.
Above yet beside these objectives comes a tremendously unexplored realm which we humans fortunately have the ability to partake in. The Divant Realm. Due to various violent and conflicting religions strongly supported in the common community today, we fear what most call evil. We believe all the creatures which we cannot touch and feel with a physical object are either entirely corrupted or good. There is no central point, there is no belief in the afterlife being a pleasant place without a higher power to protect what need not be protected due to true yet unexplored self-sufficiency and the powers our Earth gave our forefathers from the beginning of our existence. The next step that need be taken in human advancement toward the protection of our world is the very realm of which other religions have made us fear. Some call it the fourth dimension. Others describe it with words such as astral plane. We all have the ability to eliminate the negativity that can consume our lives through mere drunkenness or suicidal emotions because we are of living human essence, and in that our abilities far exceed those with little to no physical world abilities or experience. Those equipped with the right knowledge will... Those equipped with the right knowledge/will can travel into the unseen world of Divant. To assist the Sivantes in forcing away the Zodin.
Okay, we're fully on board the fucking crazy train. We are going off of the rails.
Fucking hell. Alright, by controlling and exploring Divant, we can also eliminate physical realm threats such as bioweapon construction, murders, and many more crime-related activities.
Crime-related activities. Everybody. Dear website, your YouTube your website deserves to fucking fail. Spirit science, he trippin'. I call it LSD. r/religious fruitcake. This writing sucks.
Have you ever heard the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise?
Divant equals deviant art.
Wait, what happened? Love this new Soul Calibur script. Yeah, this is the FF7 remake we need. I agree. Kumerg. Darth Onion.
Have you ever heard of the High Elves?
The truth about outside worlds. Our planet is not the only massive life form with the ability to produce smaller, less capable creatures. Amazing amounts of alien abductions and studies have been reported by oftentimes healthy and logical human beings. These abductions are most often for pure study by species in ways more advanced than us. At times, the abduction reports are merely, in reality, night terrors, otherwise known as sleep paralysis. Yet when actual events do occur, the aliens seek out what might not have been able to comprehend completely. What many may not have... Right. The studies are reaching for a goal in search of what many outsiders fail to understand. Our Earth produces unseen energies to live within our organic bodies. While outsiders are much like the simplest of our brethren animals, while also having the ability none of us are able to grasp, to learn and remember for hundreds of years as their lifespan exceeds the common physical human span 4 times. This fact is also an aspect of considering why they have advanced sooner than humans have. The planets some aliens are able to travel from oftentimes in a perspective... Wow, this is really bad writing, Jesus. This is the way he keeps... he just kept, like, padding out these fucking sentences. In a perspective, are less compliant with the laws of positive and negative, and lacking a divertive realm for the corrupted specimens to dwell. As many planets cannot rid themselves of everything they create, our Earth banned the negative projects it could not destroy to the Devant. However, some tend to break through the human psyche during our weakest points, which is oftentimes where corrupted human beings come from, the unseen world among us. The corrupt individual's vibe spread outward. So this is a vibe track, then. While attracting the other Zodan due to the unseen energies. In this, corrupted bodies are approached demonic situations. Haunted houses? Wow, this is fucking dumb. Okay. In relation to alien encounters comes an attitude much like the Zodans. What they have in common with the Zodans is that they also lack the emotion we humans are able to emit and experience regularly. This causes highly curious questions among those who visit us, and is one of the only motivations behind such visitations. Our planet, unlike so many others, is or was advanced and pure enough to come to a rightful conclusion as to how it would be able to eliminate or silence the negativities once created by those not deemed fit to occupy a human body. These are some fucking run-on sentences, man. Jesus. Sadly, the Devant would have to be exposed to the Zodans to prevent them from unleashing and destroying all hope of our planet's survival in the physical world. Yet even with this near solution, we must recognize how incomplete it really is, and as stated, we humans have the solution. So, again, this is basically just the plot of a fucking JRPG. The unseen post-living behavioral guidance. Oh, geez. Physical health. What do we got for behavioral guidance? Huh, nothing all that. Oh god, perspectives involving sexuality?
People of our history have proven to demote the value of the female gender countless times due to one major factor, physical strength. However, a contrary conclusion is held clear in our way of life. Humans were created in 2 classes, male and female, one to complement the other, and mutually so. However, in making this attempt for companionship, the free will of ego and the common male's desire for dominance came into play. Appreciation of the complexities a woman must go through in order to produce a new physical body are not respected as much as strength in the current world are by the masses. In support of both genders, we appreciate both parties for their strengths and weaknesses.
Remember, everybody, Greg is a good feminist. Greg is a good feminist boy. He wants you to know that he deserves those good boy points, everybody.
Not all people are created equal, yet by opinion, opposing sexes are beside one another, just as they are often found in life and love. A major issue that has been seen around the world for thousands of years, both in the home and the public, is those who choose to find love with the same sex instead of the opposing. By perspective of many unsympathetic citizens and even major authority figures, this way of life is seen to be a cancer in societies all over the world. Sekeska, however, has no concern of sexual preference. Our focus it is on the conservation of the Earth and those dwelling on it. Looking over this, all humans with a desire to help are welcome in our cause.
And we've got some stuff about going to the doctor and the dentist. When people see each other failing in life, they're ungroomed and unhappy. Onision really doesn't want people to go ungroomed and unhappy. That's that much we can take away from this cult. That much I think we can all agree on from our boy.
Okay, groomer. Lol at vegan space cult. Yeah, I thought Greg said he was bi. Ungroomed. Why is this a JRPG baddie?
Okay, groomer. My boy. Bad touch, bad touch. The absolute soy. My females.
Yep, impregnation fetish. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
Frozen Waifu sent me the site on Discord. I don't see anything from Frozen Waifu on here.
I don't see anything from Frozen Waifu, but I do see Zara telling me that my bear was right over Onision's face when I was reading his sex tweets, so that was cool. I did see that, and I
chose to do nothing about it. Some Gale Shield level shit. My females. Onision said he was vagina sexual. Degenerates like him belong on a cross. Heaven's Gate, anyone?
Somebody was saying that earlier, actually. I'm gonna groom ya!
I groomed, I saw, I conquered.
Oh, boy.
Onision should go to the circus. Homer sexual, I agree. Well, that's it for the Onision Sekeska. I think we've seen most of what's necessary. There's a lot more weird shit about fucking space Jesuses and, like, Devants and Zodans and whatever. Zodan of the Enders or whatever the fuck it is. There's a lot more weird shit. But, you know, I think that's fine. I think we're good for now. Is there anything else I wanted to cover while we're here? No? Oh, well, there is this weirdo on Kiwi Farms who's trying to stan, Greg. Look, dude, I'm not Onision. I'm just one of his fans. Don't be too paranoid. We exist. I wasn't trying to troll you when I made that comment about one of your female family members getting pulled off by Officer Onision. I was just being cynical. The least I could do after all the angry insults you've spewed. I just find it funny how the biggest Onision haters are the most sensitive. I used to trigger Repsion on Twitch. Epic triggering, guys! The feminists are gonna be mad! Made an account, your GF is a Nazi, and followed. That popped up on the screen, and he got angry, lol. Since then, he turned off on-screen notifications. Victory! Wow, imagine being such a small person that that's what you call victory in your life. It's incredible. Also, some guy, Stevie Wolfie, he too accused me of being Onision's alt account in one of his stream chats. His ego is too big not to respond when I comment on YouTube. So, this is apparently an Onision fan, everybody. Let me ask you something. What were your thoughts when Onision called her a social exceptional individual? Onision apparently called one of his fans a social retard because she said that he needs to, like, chill or something. I don't know exactly what she said, but she told him some basic advice that everybody probably could stand to give him. And he called her a social retard. Are you also one of his Patreons? This person asks. If you are, is it even worth the money? And Along comes the fan. No, I'm not one of his Patreon, but I spend time in his Discord with him and his Patreons few times. Some are okay, some are annoying. Me and James used to hang out on Twitch before the haters came. See, now this is how you can tell that this is Greg. He calls him James. He's calling him fucking James. That's how you know it's actually Greg. He messaged me out of the blue asking me to host him. If you met him IRL, you would be his friend too. Don't follow the bully pack mentality. These people are sick, projecting their own pedophilia onto others. I remember I met a young girl complaining about Onision not refunding her, so one of her friends gave me the money back. We can see we've got like the Autism Speaks React here, a bunch of other choice ones. So we're Water T here is quoting the fan. Relax, I don't need his attention. I'm already friends with him and he's an alright guy. How does he troll you? Well, look at his fake meltdown videos. Everyone doing reactions to them, celebrating. Look at his Twitter. He doesn't even read the replies, he just tweets provocative things and you get triggered. Guys, he's triggering you, guys. We're all just getting triggered. We're all just epic fucking feminists getting triggered, guys. It's too easy. So what if he's not making as much money? He can easily get a job and would be a much healthier lifestyle for him away from you internet leeches. He could even be a cop. How'd you like Onision to pull over your mom/sister/daughter/wife and pat her down? Now stop stalking Onision's family and worry about your own ugly, lame family and problems. Wrecked! Hey, chat. What do you think of this guy? Fucking God, Greg is a tard. Trigger the libs. Own the libs. You know, I reckon we can get Trump to tweet about Gamergate. I think we can do it. Greg goes on 4chan and Kiwi Farms to defend himself. It's Greg using wrecked unironically. Wrecked Lumafow. Oh, jeez. Calm down, Greg. He's trying to defend this orc. Epic Klinge. Wrecked with a C. Ooh. This is just sad. What an exceptional individual. Oh, I agree. I definitely agree with that. This is an exception to all exceptions. No, I'm not one of his Patreon, blah, blah, blah. Oh my God, please, it hurts too much. If you're going to sock puppet or troll, at least do it right. I don't know who says this. I don't know who said that, but that's a good one. And then, the difference is, however, Chris Hansen gives him negative attention that he hates, says Baja Blaster. It's probably the only kind of attention he doesn't like. People saying okay groomer and baby carrot to him gives him attention and doesn't. I thought I came up with okay groomer, goddammit. To him gives him attention, doesn't really do anything, but Chris Hansen is actually destroying his career and reputation, especially with how he has Gerg's exes on. And the fan comes along to say, Chris Hansen is in it for the money. Destroying Onision's career, he's beating a dead horse. His career has been going downhill for years. See, even Greg knows. I mean, even this fan, this unknown fan, agrees. No wonder Chris always complaining about YouTube not monetizing him. Boy's old. He's looking for new ways to make money. The only thing you oblivious bullies are doing is ruining his kids' lives. Be proud of yourself. Well, I would say that him and his spouse ruined their daughter's life when they negligently allowed her to just chill in a room with an open window that led her to fall two stories to almost her death. I would say, and then Greg didn't hear her screaming or anything, so she had to walk to the garage to knock on the door and get his attention. I would say that making your 2-year-old go through that is probably ruining his kids' lives a little more than anybody who's trying to get them fucking helped and saved and taken away from all that shit could ever do that. Benny the Dude says, oh, what's wrong, little buddy? You don't like other opinions? You seem sensitive. Onision is trolling you guys, and you fall for it. He has a family, a house, and a job. You focus on his every little mistake and blow it out of proportions. Oh no, he poured alcohol in some pond. We're all gonna die. Oh no, he doesn't eat meat. I'm so triggered. Lol. Wrecked. And sad cowboy cat responds, "Hey, onion boy, how's the hairline doing? Can't be shorter than your dick, right?"
Ow! Ow! Ow!
13th fucking amendment. Amendment. Wow, okay. So that's that. Thus ends the tale of Onision's fanboy, quote unquote, who's definitely not... who's definitely not Onision. And I think that'll probably do it for the stream. There's maybe some other stuff to talk about. I don't know, but I think this is good for now. We've had a very fun fair use adventure. We haven't watched a single one of his videos, and yet we've all come away with some good information. I'd be very excited to see if this one gets content claimed. This is spicy. I can't wait. Let's see. Let's get some super chats going on. Let's round these out here. $5 from Dart Star the Return. Still can't believe this is the I'm a banana guy. And then a banana emoji. Yeah, there was a period there on one of his YouTube accounts where most of his uploads were just various different versions of the banana song. Or like sequels to the banana song. I don't know. It was really sad, honestly. Like trying to resurrect some meme from 10 years ago. $5 from Marissa Cohn. I'm grooming! Very good. Very nice. Very, very nice and hot. $5 from ZZZZZZ. Greg wants to claim he's God? He'll be less than a paving stone in hell once 5 hours at jail time Freddy Fuckbear breaks him in two. Wow, that's quite descriptive. Freddy Fuckbear. Thank you. $5 from MC Lemon. Saw your community post, and what was that about possible criminal negligence? Well, I mean, I hope you're caught up to speed now. Yeah, the daughter, Greg's daughter, fell out of a fucking window because him and the spouse were a little too busy. Dealing with their whole lives falling apart to take care of their daughter. So, but yeah, that happened. That's really cool. $5 from Dev Cork. When I was a child at VidCon in 2011, he asked to film my friend and I dancing, as well as many other kids. Really creepy in retrospect. Wow, okay. That's very interesting. VidCon 2011, huh? I very interested by that. That's very... Wow, okay. Thank you for sharing. $5 from Her Hensley. He's a disgrace to everything that exists. Onision isn't great either. I guess you're talking about Chris Hansen? Yeah. $2 from Logan Galloway. Groomer's about as old as my dad. Yeah, he's an old-ass man. $2 from Girk Garb. Onision debated a sock on while Kai was pregnant. Yeah, I think I remember something about that. He was, like, on YouTube talking to a sock puppet. It was very sad. F's in chat. $2 from Josie Christensen. Greg would be Griffith from Berserk. Yeesh. No, I disagree. Griffith is cool. Greg would probably be one of the nameless weirdos who tries to rape Casca or something and then gets, like, cut into 700 pieces by Guts. Guts it. That would probably be what Greg is. $5 from Okidoki. I was just looking at Onision shit from 9 years ago to find something. He looked like Sangi, dude. Where's our boy? Where the fuck is our boy? We need this... You know what? Because you're right. And this stream, ladies and gentlemen, is Sangi approved. This is a Sangi approved stream. $2 from internet user 666. Can I draw you Voring Onion? I would prefer if you didn't, but I mean, I can't stop you, I guess. So, you know, go with God. $5 from Crazy Ace King. First time getting to a live stream, and may I say, you're damn good. Thank you for your service of covering freaks of the vilest nature. Yeah, you know, from zoo sadists like Sangi to fucking Onision, and nothing's off the table, but thank you. I appreciate that. $2 from Katie McCulloch. Onision does not pass the vibe check. Definitely not. No pass.
$2 from LincolnMan84. Snake Thing, Onision, Pamperchu, Free For All. Who wins? Well, Snake Thing is a little bitch, and he's Snake Thing preys on things that are smaller than him, and so does Onision, I guess, allegedly. But at least the ones that Onision preys on are like a little older, I guess. I don't know. I think Onision would probably win amongst those three. Onision is definitely the alpha Chad of the weird, like, creepy fuckers that we've talked about. $2 from Jane Doe. No message. Thank you. $5 from Alyssa Richardson. He's so shit at rhyming. I bet my left tit he doesn't know what multisyllabics are. And he just repeatedly rhymes action with action. He's rhyming erection with erection. Yeah. Yeah, that one, again, that one song where he's like, don't deny you like ice cream, was wonderful. And, like, I didn't even realize how bad it was when I first saw it, but I looked at that song again. I watched that video again a little while ago, just to get an idea of how bad his music was again. And I got to that song and I was like, wow, he really is just doing anything he can to rhyme these words. And even if it doesn't make sense, don't deny you love ice cream. $2 from Mark Mendez. Can't make copyright claims in jail. Yeah, you know, I gotta say, like, he claimed my video. He claimed my Onision music video, even though he claimed it months and months ago, immediately when I put it up. He claimed this one again, like, last night. And I was not even that mad for me. I haven't earned any money off of that video, a single cent. I've not earned anything from that. But, and he's gotten all of that revenue. But I wasn't so mad for me. I was more pissed off because I follow a YouTuber named Cecil McFly who does videos about Onision, and she's been doing like this ongoing like documentary style series about all of his fuck ups and throughout his whole like existence on the internet, and like he keeps copyright claiming her. He keeps fucking doing that, and she's like, I don't even know if I want to finish the series anymore. And it's sad. It's sad that he's able to, like, break the fucking rules, break the law of copyright, just to, like, no time for victory music, not yet. But it's sad that he's able to break the law of copyright to bully people into silence. And, you know, that's why we're doing a fair use adventure today, ladies and gents. We are, we're doing a fair use adventure because, you know, I would love for him to try and copyright claim this, me reading his tweets and, like, the news about what happened. I would love for that to happen. That would be great. It would be really a shame if he got sued instead of him trying to sue Rapzion and Chris Hansen. That would really suck for him if that happened. Let's see. $5 from Jesterhead. Oh, did I say the can't make copyright claims in jail? That was $2 from Mark Mendez. I'm not sure if I mentioned that. Let's see. $5 from Jesterhead. Unpopular opinion. Onion's dad didn't beat him hard enough. Well, I mean, that's, I don't know how unpopular of an opinion that's going to be in this chat, but I mean, not a bully stream. $2 Canadian from Garfield Phone. Bro, is the stream ending? I fucking missed an hour and 30. Well, that was an hour ago, so no, you caught some of it. But don't worry, the whole thing's going to be archived. We want it to be nice and available, just in case anybody tries to pull some illegal shit. Thanks for providing inspiration for painting, says Camille Taggart with $2. Thank you for deciding to paint while you watch me talk about nonsense. I appreciate that. That is actually quite the compliment when I hear people say that they paint stuff or whatever while they listen to me. That's nice. $10 from Skrix. Here you go, Daddy Claw. You keep me going at work, but why is it okay? Why is it always a day I stock yogurt when hearing this shit? Careful. Careful. Try not to vomit all over the yogurt. You'll be fine. $5 from Warm Shadow 77. No message. Thank you. $5 from Alyssa Richardson. Also, I 100% guarantee his neurosyphilitic lizard brain anti-drug stance came from him being a loser in high school, and he never got invited to parties. Yeah, that whole weird. Like, I'm not
I smoke a lot of pot, and anybody who knows the stream knows me, but I don't do anything but anything else, you know? Like, and I don't think I ever would, particularly. I'm pretty anti-drug as far as people go, outside of, like, marijuana. So it's weird, even for me, like, listening to him go off about that shit is just like, dude, you're not winning any points by being straight edge in 2020. Like, what do you want? What are you expecting to get from this? This is sad. 149 rubles from 420 with a message that I can't read, but it's M backwards R Y. I don't know what that means, but thank you. 2 euros from Marius Danis. Your depressed voice is why I watched you. Well, I endeavor to always be in a bad mood for you guys then. 2 pounds from a night elf. Thanks for fueling my alcohol addiction this evening. Oh, see, I was not so lucky. I started streaming at 9 a.m. So, for me anyway. So, I wasn't socially... it wasn't socially acceptable for me to break open the jack. But we might be watching Suburban Nights later. No promises. But that could happen. I might need to pass out early again because I fucking drank too much. That could always happen. $2 from Jane Doe. Greg is the freak barber from Courage the Dog. Yeah. Makes sense. 40 rubles from F.U. Susan. Let's just call Grug Coomer Groomer. I like that. That's a good one. It's like how Medicare is the Boomer Groomer. But instead, he's a Coomer Groomer. That's good. 50 NOK from NTW. Geez, Onion Boy sounds like the moldy orange in the Oval Office. Politics, everybody. Yeah, he did though. There was a period when we were reading those emails, he did legitimately have that like this news is all fake, it's all very, very unfair, very unprofessional, very biased against me. It's a very similar kind of thing. I felt that too. $5 from old Grandpap Diabetes. The full report warning child injury. Okay, so there's a link here. That's interesting. Hang on. Let me take a look right now. Someone has a link here to reddit.com/r/onision. Copy that. Put this over here. Hey Chad, how you doing? Freaky Fred did nothing wrong. Oh, geez, this is... Oh, fuck. This is, long. Oh, geez. Okay, I don't want to read this. If you'd like to read this, old Grandpap Diabetes has super chatted $5 to let me know that there is a full report of this Onision daughter falling out of the window thing. There's a full, like, I think it's slightly redacted, but it's in more detail than I'd care to read about, like, an actual child being hurt. So that's available if you'd like to read it. I guess I can probably post the link in the chat. Go check it out. If you'd like to see the full thing, you can do that. I'm not going to be reading it, though. It's a little bit... I don't want to say gruesome, because, again, the girl is going to, like, live, but it's pretty rough, and I don't feel like reading it. But thank you for sharing that, old Grandpap Diabetes. Appreciate it. Diabetes. $5 from Welcome to the Center of the Earth, I suppose. I've never seen someone work so hard to completely destroy their own career like this. Amazing. Yeah, I think that came in during the email segment, and I agree. It was like watching the Hindenburg go down. It was quite wonderful. $2 from Annabelle Anzalone. Oh, whoa, does he just want to fucking die? I think so. $2 from Meow Killia. Using you to test why my card is broken. Hi, Claw. Hello. I guess it's not broken. Thank you. $20 from the rookie. Some motherfuckers always trying to ice skate uphill.
Yeah, that's a pretty good. That's a pretty accurate. You know, that's pretty much what this is. $5 from Stephen Lofton. Never mind, we don't need audio of this. I don't know what that was in reference to. $5 from Connor Logan. Has it been mentioned that Greg, when babysitting an infant for a friend, wouldn't change its diaper because it would be inappropriate? Yeah, I remember that. I kind of agreed actually with his thing though. He was like, would you want your friend like touching your child? But I guess if you left the child with the person, you would probably expect that person to like change the baby. So yeah, I mean, I guess so. That is a little weird. It kind of sounds like an excuse, like he just didn't want to fucking do it. I don't know. But yeah, $5 from Squid. I just came back and I'm listening to some space cult stuff. Are we still talking about the Onion? Unless I'm just having a stroke and I'm hallucinating. Oh, well, that was Onision. Yes, that was indeed him. That was his cult. He tried to make a fucking cult. It's called Sekeska, and it's weird. It's pretty weird. But it's also not that interesting. $5 from Galaxy Man. So far up his own ass, he turned inside out and then back again. I agree. That explains his lovely, young, youthful skin. $2 from the Spicy Shibe. Why does all of this read like a DeviantArt fanfic? Pretty much. The Sekeska stuff. Pretty much. $2 from Sucky Sucky. Onision gonna be giving those Sucky Suckies in jail. Wonderful name. I mean, pretty much. $2 from Alyssa Richardson. He's the world's most prolific same fag. Yeah. I think everybody knows. Anytime you see somebody who's still supporting Onision, you can be pretty sure. It's possible that the 4chan posts we looked at were just a troll, but I don't know. I like the idea that it was actually him. Somebody, £2 default name just says green text wrecked. Green text wrecked indeed. Maggie09Abel with 60 rubles. Hi. Well, hello. Hello there. $5 from Ash O. Greg talks like one of the bad guys from Advent Children. Well, that might have been the Final Fantasy music swaying your opinion, but it is very theatrical, at least back then. That was back like 2005 or something, so it is a pretty old thing, but it seems to somewhat, I don't know, fall in line with some of his views now, so I don't know. Get off my lawn, you rapscallions, with $2. More Onision evidence, I guess. There's a YouTube link. And what do we got here? We got a YouTube link. Where does this take us? Okay, this is just a link to my stream, so I don't know if that's evidence, but I mean, you know, I'll appear in court and finger Onision as the guy that illegally claimed my videos. $2 from Joma. I'm actually painting as I watch too. Lol. Well, that's nice. I hope you make something very disgusting and greasy in Greg's honor. $5 from Daddy Vio. As perverted as I am, I feel secure in the fact that I'm not as fucked up as Onision and any of the other creepy fucks you talk about on your channel. Yeah, I mean, you know, perversion is fine as long as it's, you know, between adults, loving and consensual, and doesn't involve any dogs or anything like that. $2 from the Spicy Shibe. The corner Sengi is horrifying. Thank you. You're welcome. This is a Sengi-approved stream. $5 from Flurpy Smurp. Got to leave for work soon, so here you go. Love your content. Thank you. And finally, £5 from Teddy. Careful, Papa. You'll end up in his basement with a shaved head, tucking a baby carrot up the toot fruit boot hole on the daily. I'm just toot fruit goofing. I'm very worried about that. You're right. I mean, honestly, if Greg wanted to fight me, I think with my hook hand, I'd have a, and the fact that I'm not Onision, I think I'd have a pretty good shot. But you know, we don't need to solve our problems with violence. That's fine. Thanks everybody for watching the stream. This has been a pretty good time. Some grim subjects at times, but you know, I thought it was pretty fun. We made the most of it. We turned his daddy dom on main into something that was an enjoyable experience, and I'm thankful that all of you joined and chose to sit with me. Oh, we got 5 pounds from Abigail English. Onision didn't want to change the baby because he thought doing so would be implicitly sexual because he's already attracted to young girls. Yeah, I think that is pretty telling that the first thing you think of when it's about when somebody like when you have to change a baby is, oh, that would be sexual. I wouldn't want to do that. That's pretty telling, I'd say. I feel like that says a lot about your boy. But yeah, that'll about do it for the stream, folks. Once again, thank you for joining, and try not to be the next Onision, everybody. What song do we got here? Oh, it's this one. Here's a good outro song. Take care, folks. Love ya. Penis.
You were meant to love my cock.
Okay, I'll stop. Bye.